Belief, longtime readers said even the comic's most exciting stories are regularly ruined by the implausibility of a thriving daily newspaper, whose advertising revenue and circulation numbers have not at all been threatened by a media landscape overtaken by laptops, smartphones, and aggregation websites.
Look, I could play along with Superman using his breath to freeze a volcano, or clapping his hands together to cause some sort of sonic boom, but seeing images of a thriving Daily Planet newsroom not facing layoffs or dwindling home subscriptions just really takes me out of the story. No one in Metropolis has realized they could get news online faster and for free.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free and take control of the airwaves on this live Saturday edition of the program. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, of course, as always, interesting stuff to talk about. You can, of course, bring whatever you want to the table with you in the studio tonight. It's Ian.
And Daryl.
Don't forget, you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com. There's always something interesting there because of listeners like you who have taken the time to submit content right to the front page of the site. You can vote up what you like and vote down what you don't over at freetalklive.com. Jeffrey Tucker, who has been on the show a number of times in the past as a guest, in-studio guest, when we're at like the Liberty Forum or the Porcupine Freedom Festival. He's always a fun guy to have
Coins on. In the Kingdom.
That's right. Yeah, he was on with us there as well. He's an interesting character, and he's got himself a website over at liberty.me, specifically his blog on that site, which is tucker.liberty.me, and the blog title is a little incendiary. I think a lot of people are going to be upset when they read it. It's titled
or when they hear it.
It's titled Legalize Drunk Driving. Let me jump right in. Most people have been there. A few drinks at a restaurant or bar and then into the car to get home. Am I over the legal limit? Hard to say. Is my driving impaired? It doesn't seem to be, but what if I get stopped? Will I lose my license, go to jail, and be disgraced in front of the community? It's a frightening prospect. What's especially strange about this is the reason I fear. My arrest and punishment would not be for driving recklessly or for endangering other drivers. It would be because I failed a test of something that is not materially related to my actual driving. The law is arbitrary and shifts with the political season. The perpetrators can't really be sure if they're over or under the limit unless you buy your own BAC tester.
Right.
And we all have vast experience with people who drink surprising amounts of liquor and drive all the time but never get into accidents and don't seem to be driving in an unsafe way. Then there are the frequent cases in which cops arrest people for DUI who are stopped for something else, like a burned-out taillight. I know people who've been arrested in their own driveways, says Tucker, having gotten home safely and harmed no one. How about the people who will go out into their car at a bar? You know, they're in the bar, they're drinking, they know they're too drunk to drive. It's cold, so, you know, they get into their car and they put the key in the ignition and start up the car so they can stay warm out there. That's technically DUI as well.
Right. Even if they're in the passenger seat.
Yeah, if the key's in the ignition, right?
If the vehicle is on, I believe is the rule, at least in New Hampshire.
Yeah, there's
and the rule
rules
is
everywhere.
Different everywhere.
Right, right. So don't take this as legal advice. I don't know if this is the case anywhere, but I feel like I've heard a story about somebody getting arrested for just having the keys like in the vicinity of the front seat of the car, not even in the ignition.
That would not be surprising.
Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me either. I don't remember which state that was or, you know, what the circumstances were there. But if you want to tell us your story, you're welcome to join us here. We'll get into Tucker's reasons why he thinks drunk driving should be legalized. But if you've got an experience maybe you've had with the police or you are a cop, toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So there's all kinds of stories, you know.
I've even heard stories of people getting a DUI for riding a bicycle down the street.
Yeah.
Intoxicated, for riding a riding lawnmower down the sidewalk.
I've never understood that. I mean, that's clearly one of those things where, well, you know, we're doing this for your protection, right? Because if you're riding a bicycle, odds are good you're going to be the one who gets hurt if there's some sort of an accident that,
right.
that happens. I mean, if you're on a bike, they're in a car.
I've never heard a story of, you know, drunk bicyclist mows down 27 right. in a flea market, but I have heard drunk driver mows down people in a flea market.
Never made sense to me. Now, you know, I guess you'd have to probably be pretty drunk to get pulled over on a bicycle for, you know.
Or live in a small town with bored cops.
Could be. Share your story at 855-450-FREE. So more from Tucker. He says clearly, he says there are frequent cases where cops arrest people for, you know, these variants on DUI where they're not even driving. They're arrested and imprisoned. A humiliating and terrible experience for anyone to go through. Clearly, this DUI enforcement has been a boon to the police, but has it really curbed drunk driving? He doesn't mention in here, but don't forget the DUI checkpoints as well.
Certainly.
That's part of that enforcement apparatus where they are just wholesale checking people's identification, sniffing around people's cars, poking around, being nosy, asking probing questions, all under the auspices of looking for drunks, when in point of fact, in a lot of these DUI checkpoints, nobody even gets arrested for DUI.
Right.
They'll pop somebody for, you know, having a joint in the ashtray or not having their paperwork up to date.
And what they'll do down in Texas, and I'm sure this happens in other states as well, they have what they call no refusal weekend, where they'll mm-hmm. put up these DUI checkpoints. If you refuse to blow in the breathalyzer, that is considered probable cause
yep.
to have you arrested, taken to a hospital, and blood forcibly drawn.
It's crazy. Clearly, this enforcement has been a boon to the police, he says. But you might consider staking out your local bar. Has it really curbed drunk driving? He says, follow how much people drink and then observe how many of them get into their cars afterwards. I'll just state what most everyone knows, but hardly anyone says. Drinking and driving is a national sport in the United States. In the vast, vast majority of cases, no harm is done. Murray Rothbard once told me that he thought drunk driving should be legal. I was stunned and shocked that anyone would say such a thing. But over time, I began to see his point. It's not outrageous at all. He was exactly right. With laws against DUI, what's being criminalized? Not reckless driving as such. Not aggression against anyone. What's being criminalized is the chemical makeup of the blood in your body. That itself should be no crime. To make having a certain blood content illegal is essentially totalitarian. But, you say, that drinking is associated with bad driving. Well, enforce the laws against reckless driving. Many more people drink and drive than drive recklessly. Some people drive even more safely after a few drinks, correcting for their delayed responses. We do this all the time. For instance, after a workout, when we're sleepy or when we're angry or whatever, human beings adapt with rationality. And you know what happens on New Year's, some other holiday, people always say, be careful, there are lots of drunk drivers out there. Just the prospect alone makes everyone drive more defensively. Regardless, the law has no business criminalizing associated peaceful behaviors rather than real crimes against person and property. For example, grudges are associated with murder in the sense that a vast number of murderers are carrying a grudge. Do we make grudges illegal? That would be crazy and unenforceable, even if there were some chemical way to measure what constitutes a grudge. But we make driving under the influence illegal, though it is roughly the same thing. It targets an associated condition rather than the crime itself. Laws against drunk driving have vastly expanded police power and done nothing to stop the practice. The best prevention against unsafe driving from drinking has been provided privately. Friends, services offered by bars and restaurants. It's not uncommon for a bartender to call a cab for a
right.
regular customer who is, you know, has had too much, clearly.
And I still think, let me just interject here. I still think that it would be a brilliant move for a cab company to work out some sort of deal with local bars
mm-hmm.
to where they will give free rides to intoxicated people.
That happens. Bars actually do pay cab companies for these free rides, right? Like the cab company is getting a spiff from the bar, essentially. Like,
right.
okay, this guy's bought 10 beers, you know, we'll give some of the money to the cabbies. And then it's also good for the cab company because they get name recognition and people are more likely to use them in the future. for that. Community interest groups, of course, also provide these assistances. And he says this is the humane and rational way that societies deal with social risks. The police have only messed up this process by adding a coercive element that targets liberty rather than crime. He says, and we can see where this is heading. Texting is now illegal in most places. So is talking on the phone. Maybe talking itself should be illegal. I mean, you can be distracted by someone in the passenger seat.
You could be distracted by eating a cheeseburger, by, you know, changing the channel on the radio. And I forget where it is. There's a proposal somewhere to require that cell phones shut off if they are going faster than 5 miles per hour.
He says right here that some communities are talking about banning eating while driving. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Should drunk driving be legalized? You can share your thoughts with us on Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realists, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
I was a pedestrian and an asinine cop backed up and hit me and knocked me down to the ground. And I said, I think we need to call the police as I'm, you know, screaming in pain. And he said, go ahead, I'm a cop too. And he left the scene of the accident.
Oh, wow.
So when the police and the ambulance and all the paramedics arrived to take me to the hospital, because I have knee damage now and need knee replacements to both knees because of his actions. And I told him, I said, you know, I'm a registered nurse. I work drug and alcohol rehab. This guy was drunk. I could see it. I could tell by his, you know, his actions. He was drunk. And I said, I want a blood alcohol done on him. They knew who he was. They waited 6 hours to go to his home to arrest him. And, of course, by then he had sobered up.
Sure.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at LRN.FM.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here on this live Saturday edition of the program. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and in studio with you tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And Daryl.
And you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features we have there for you. If you care about online privacy, you need to know about ProXPN. Just drop by proxpn.com/FTL to get started. Grab their free software, get it installed for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, and Android devices. Once you do that, your internet connection becomes encrypted, meaning that your ISP will not be able to spy on you anymore. They won't know which websites you're visiting, and they won't be able to log that information, which they're probably doing right now. And of course, they'll turn that log over to pretty much any law enforcement agency that calls up and asks some real nice, like, a lot of these guys will do that. So if you want to protect your privacy, you've got to have ProXPN. That's one step. It's not the only thing you should do to protect your privacy. I also recommend PGP and some other, you know, important ideas. But ProXPN is a good step in the right direction, and it's affordable. You can get it for 50% off the price of their annual account by using our discount code, which is FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live and the number 50. And by the way, that discount is good for the lifetime of the account. So when you're ready to renew on the following year, it's the same awesome discount. And by the way, Linux users, you can use ProXPN. It's just a different setup process. So go and get started for free over at proxpn.com/FTL. And then when you're ready to upgrade to get the premium account with unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. Just do that with code FTL50 at proxpn.com/FTL. And don't forget, there's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. You've got nothing to lose here but your privacy. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. That's proxpn.com/FTL. Code is FTL50. As we go to the phones and the fun, let's talk to, by the way, the question, in case you're just tuning in, was how do you feel about the idea of legalizing drunk driving? That's what Jeffrey Tucker is saying over at tucker.liberty.me. Let's go to Dave. He's in Virginia listening to WNIS. Dave, you're on with Ian and Daryl.
How you doing tonight?
Hey, Dave, go ahead.
I'm a retired local police officer here. My experience with the whole thing is that would be not a really good idea. The problem is what y'all were talking about earlier about it, you know, like having a grudge and that this is a physiological thing. This is not a moral or criminal thing in any way, shape, or form. It's a physiological fact that when the average person gets up to about a 0.08 or 0.10 blood count, that they are not in a position to drive a car. I mean, it's just if
the average person, but you would agree that there are some people who can operate just fine.
No, because it's not a question of whether or not you got home this time or not without crashing into anybody. It's a question of whether or not you are capable of competently operating the car in the same manner as you would be if you were sober. And at 0.08, trust me, you are not.
So then you'd probably support a crackdown on driving while drowsy, while sleepy, right? Like, you know, because for you, if you're not operating at tip top shape, you deserve to be in a jail cell. Is that right?
No, that's not the same thing. The difference is because we all get drowsy.
Well, wait a minute. You don't have to be short on sleep before you get into a car. I mean, you're choosing to get behind the wheel as a drowsy person.
That's exactly right. And if you do, and there are many, that's exactly why we have laws that don't allow truck drivers to drive more than 13 hours in a 24-hour period for that very same reason. Because it is incumbent upon the person who gets behind the wheels to be in the proper shape to drive the car.
But you would totally go on a crackdown, right? Like if they were doing a drowsy driving crackdown, you'd participate in that as a former law enforcement officer.
I wouldn't even know how to do a drowsy driving.
Yeah, you could pull over people that are yawning And I don't know how you test for
people,
it.
People, you know, slamming back Red Bulls or Rockstar energy drinks.
Evidence of possible drowsiness.
We can take the probable cause that comes that is required in order to make a vehicle stop for any reason, and you can stretch it to the ridiculous as you're trying to do.
Oh no, you guys do that. I mean, the cops do that all the time. I mean, haven't you ever been through a DUI checkpoint?
No,
you want to talk about stretching probable cause.
I have never participated in a DUI checkpoint, and I don't believe that they should be done.
Oh, interesting.
There is no probable cause.
Okay. Well, we're on the same page on that one, Dave. I'll give you credit for that one.
Let me trust me. I am not what you would call I don't know how to put this, but at any rate, I don't believe in DUI checkpoints. I don't believe in consent searches. I think it's a violation of the Fourth Amendment.
Okay.
I don't care what the Constitution says or what the
you're winning
Supreme
points here,
Court
Dave.
Says.
You're winning points now. Like I like what you're saying there.
Well, what about distracted driving? Like I like to listen to talk radio, and occasionally I'll get upset at one of the idiot hosts, and I'll start yelling at the radio. Should I, you know, be stopped from driving until I calm down?
I don't know how, I don't know what mechanism a police officer would use to stop you for that. See, this is where we come in, and this is what people don't understand about DUI. Police officers, by and large, stop the worst of the DUIs because they have to have probable cause to make the stop. Now, if you do something like, you know, if you got a burned out taillight, or if you, you know, your tags are bad or something like that, and we pull you over and it becomes apparent to us that you are under the influence of alcohol, that's a separate issue.
Okay, so hold on. Let's talk about this burned out taillight thing, because I'm sure you've probably heard about the Supreme Court decision that came out about a month ago, where in North Carolina, there was a police officer that pulled someone over because one of the taillights was burned out. North Carolina law does not require two taillights, but yet this guy wound up getting busted for drugs because of a search that never should have happened.
Exactly. I agree with you 100%. The dummy should have never consented to that search.
But he never should have been pulled over.
Well, yes, this is true. He shouldn't have been pulled over if it's not illegal in North Carolina to have a burned out taillight.
But the Supreme Court ruled that cops can have a flawed understanding of the law. So if you just happen to think that you need two taillights and then you pull somebody over.
Right. But I've already established that I don't always agree with the Supreme Court just by virtue of the fact
that he's not defending the entire system.
Right. But
I am not defending the entire system, believe me.
But the point that I'm trying to make, Dave, is that you do have to admit that sometimes police officers will pull someone over for a reason that they never should have been pulled over in the first place, and then that leads to other things.
Yes, and more often than being pulled over for something that's not illegal, they are pulled over for something that's illegal. But it's the intent is not necessarily to take action against that offense. They're looking for something else.
So, Dave, then I presume that you also, since you don't support things like checkpoints, that you would also not support the prosecution of people who are trying to sleep it off, you know, like they're sitting in the bar parking lot with the keys in the ignition.
No, I don't.
Keeping warm.
I don't. I wouldn't support that.
Well, I appreciate your humanity. I can definitely see that you have it. Thank you for the call tonight, Dave. I appreciate that. You know, toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. If more cops thought that way, I think we'd have a better world.
Yes.
More coming up here in moments. 855-450-FREE. Should drunk driving be legalized, however? There's more arguments here that Tucker will cite. We'll get to that. It's Free Talk Live.
I lost 18 pounds in just 4 days. Hi, I'm James Zetta. If you're like me, you've already tried and failed at many diet and weight loss plans. The 18 and 4 weight loss plan requires no exercising, no diet pills or additives, no laxatives, no meal replacements, and no diet drinks. The 18 and 4 program is crystal clear with a day-to-day, step-by-step, and meal-to-meal guide. If you're not satisfied with your results, I will give you my 30-day full money-back guarantee. Go to 18and4.com. That's the number 18, IN, the number 4.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Hello, Americans. It's Uncle Sam here. If you owe $10,000 or more on your federal or state income taxes, I've got important news that may help you negotiate a lower tax bill. The IRS, with their Fresh Start initiative, is offering more flexible terms to Americans looking to settle their IRS debt. They can help you lift your wage garnishments, stop bank levies, and put your tax problem behind you once and for all. If you owe tens of thousands or even hundreds of thousands of dollars to the IRS or state, our team of tax professionals can resolve your case and stop collection actions against you. Even if you've been audited or haven't filed a return in years, we can help. Call right now and find out if you qualify to settle your debt for far less than what you owe. 800-978-3909. 800-978-3909. 800-978-3909. 800-978-3909.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here. It's the live Saturday edition, and the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Jeffrey Tucker over at Liberty.me is saying, legalize drunk driving. Is he crazy? Does he just want people going all kinds all over the road, running into trees, running into people, dogs? I mean, he just wants anarchy.
Well, he actually does advocate for no government, but he's not advocating for people to be reckless driving. Mm-hmm. He actually says that, you know, most of the time when people are pulled over for drunk driving, they're not being pulled over because they are driving reckless. If the reckless driving laws were being enforced, there would be fewer people getting busted for DUI.
Well, wait a minute. I think maybe you misspoke. Or maybe that was what Tucker said, but as that former officer pointed out, and I think he's right, a lot of people do get pulled over for recklessly driving, and then they catch a drunk driving charge.
But there are also a lot of people that get pulled over for bogus things like a brake light out.
Going too slowly as well.
I've been pulled over too slowly.
When I was a teenager, I was like 17 or something like that. I was taking some friends home and we were driving east of the interstate in Sarasota, Florida. And there's a point on Clark Road where it goes, there's one of those yellow signs. And I didn't know that a yellow sign was suggested speed, you know, like the speed limit where it's all yellow. I didn't know that that was a suggested speed.
I have no clue what you're talking about. I've never seen a yellow speed limit sign.
Look for them. You'll see them in New Hampshire
sometimes. Oh, wait, you're talking about like the thing in like the school zone. That's generally the only place you ever see them.
School zone's definitely not yellow. No, those are white. Those are real speed limits. When that time frame is happening, that's a real speed limit.
Yeah, so it's very rare situations. Like you'll see on-ramp to an interstate.
Interstates, that's usually where you'll see them. Yep. So anyway, this was just kind of going around a curve, and it was this yellow sign, and so I did the 25 miles an hour or whatever, and there was a cop behind me. He pulls me over for that.
Based on what the sign says. Okay.
And when I asked him about it, he said it was because I could have been drunk. And that would have been the reason. That was one of the reasons why someone would go the suggested speed limit around that curve. That was his motivation. Now, I wasn't drunk. I hadn't been drinking at all. We did actually have some alcohol in the back of the truck. And to give the guy credit, he actually, you know, didn't arrest us for that. He made my cohorts dump out the beers because we were all under 21 at the time. But we didn't end up catching a charge, so I guess it could have been a lot worse. But it was an interesting rationale for pulling someone over. You were doing the suggested speed that we posted, and so that means you're probably drunk. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Jeffrey Tucker says, legalize drunk driving. What do you say? Let's go to Connor. He's listening in Virginia to WNIS. Hey, Connor.
Hey, man. I think that Jeffrey Tucker guy is kind of a fool.
Why is that?
I go to school around here in Virginia Beach. I go to Tidewater, just local college, and I've had a lot of friends pass away, especially recently, from drunk driving.
Mm.
And I believe...
So the laws didn't stop them then, huh?
Yeah, I mean, most time it's personal judgment. It's on you is whether you're going to get in the car or not. But it's the .08 thing that kind of has people thrown because you can drive totally straight at .08.
That's not what that cop said. Now, I agree with you, by the way. I think most people would acknowledge that .08 is not particularly impaired for a lot of people.
And before, like, the early 2000s, late 1990s, depending on where you live, the legal limit was .10.
Yeah. So, apparently, yeah. So, I mean, there's just an arbitrary number plucked out of thin air by, you know, some bureaucrats. And but it's important, Connor, to note that these people that you know that have died due to drunk driving, either as the victims of a drunk driver or the drunk driver themselves, you know, those who were doing the drinking and driving, obviously the laws didn't stop them, right? I mean, drunk driving's got some pretty serious penalties in most places. Why didn't the law stop them from...
Yeah, see, the law is, that's what I have in concern, is the law is there to... Mostly officers, well, I've been pulled over and they constantly ask me, have you been drinking? Have you been drinking? Like, just to get me out of the car to see, to breathalyze me and check and see. And I know not to. I know, I mean, even if I have, I mean, it's not many of their business unless they have total consent, meaning I can smell it or they can see it. So I know my rights as in if I have or am, you know what I mean? But the fact is that the law is there to catch you. It's not to prevent you. So I don't.
But there are some people that say that the law is there to serve as a deterrent.
Right. That's the argument.
That's the whole point of having the law.
That's the argument from the law and order types, from the people who, you know, we believe, well, this is a nation of laws. You know, they believe that laws change people's behavior. And there may be evidence that it changes a few people's behavior. But it doesn't seem like it changes most people's behavior. I mean, like you're saying, you know, plenty of people who are going to have a few drinks at a bar and they're going to hop in the car and drive home. And in fact, I bet you there's plenty of cops that do that too. I bet you they do it on a regular basis.
I've also had plenty of friends that have been pulled over, taken out, and the cop, they've admitted to the police that they've been drinking and they were just trying to make it home. And the police have let them back in the car and let them drive home. Because that was just the officer. They followed them, of course, but they just wanted them to get home, and they didn't want the whole process of having to deal with an underage DUI case.
Well, you know, if for any cops that do that, they deserve kudos. And I thank you for the call, Connor. Appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. If a cop actually helps you get home in an inebriated state, wow, now that sounds like service to me.
And in some places, if, you know, let's just say that you live close enough to the bar that you decide, I'm going to be responsible, walk to the bar,
it's illegal to walk,
get
drunk,
and then walk home. You can still get arrested for being
public
drunk in
intoxication.
Public.
Or what do they call it here? Protective custody is the magic legal term that they use here in Keene, New Hampshire, where if a law enforcement officer determines that based on their arbitrary decision that you are too drunk to be in public, like, you know, I guess the classic definition of this would be somebody who's stumbling down the middle of a highway or something, right?
Right.
That if you are too drunk to be walking, they will arrest you. It's not in New Hampshire, it's not a criminal charge. It just results in you going to jail until you are no longer
sleep
drunk.
It off.
Yeah.
And remember, there was the one bar in Keene where we live that they got their license taken away, their liquor license taken away for a few days because some drunk girl walked outside and she like tripped over something on the sidewalk.
That's right.
And liquor enforcement was there and asked if she was drunk. And she was like, yeah, I'm drunk. And so
boom,
they took the bar's liquor
down.
License because it's illegal to serve an intoxicated person alcohol.
There's so many crazy laws that the state has surrounding alcohol. And what's so wrong with the idea of having a situation where the police actually care about people? You know, I hear rumors, Daryl, it certainly hasn't happened in my lifetime, that are very similar to what the caller was suggesting there, that, you know, in the past, it was supposedly more likely that a cop that discovered someone driving drunk would drive that person home. And, you know, what Connor just suggested sort of was a variant on that. Follow the person home.
Right.
That way you don't have to deal with a tow. But that sounds like service. That sounds like something I could get behind. Like, okay, yeah. This person's a danger. Pull the person over for dangerous driving. Then,
which is also illegal.
Right. Then determine if the person is drunk and
or
offer
sleepy.
Them a ride home. Or sleepy. Yeah. Hey, are you too out of it to drive? Can I help you? Can I help you get home? That's what service is about. I don't want the service of being locked in a prison cell and then possibly losing my job because
right.
of a little indiscretion. And let's continue with your calls and thoughts. James is listening in Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live, James. James in Virginia in Newport News. James going once. Someone's there. James going twice. We'll put him back on hold. Maybe he'll come back around. Let's continue with Casper. He is in New Jersey listening to WVNJ. Hey, Casper.
Hi. I think it should be strictly enforced in every way because who is most vulnerable? Pedestrians and cyclists, they're the ones that pay the real cost of this, someone
drinking
and
driving. Strictly enforced. I would like to hear more, Casper. If you can hang on, I want to know what you would do differently, because some would say it is not strict enough. The checkpoints that they have and the intrusiveness, not strict enough. What would Casper like to see?
He does not sound like a friendly ghost.
No. 855-450-FREE. More coming up. This is the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
It's the end of year clearance sale at Lumber Liquidators. We'd rather sell it than count it. So every floor and every store is on sale, and it all must go. Get incredible deals on first quality flooring from just 35 cents a square foot. Beautiful 3/4 inch pre-finished solid hardwood is just $179. Save even more on all liquidation clearance and closeouts. If it's in stock, it's on sale, and pay no interest until January 2017. Don't miss these end of year deals in over 400 floors. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Alex Jones here. For the last 2 years, I've been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to design a nutraceutical formulation that has truly life-changing health benefits. So many other formulations out there contain toxic ingredients, synthetic additives, and even GMOs. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure Ancient Defense for you and your family. Visit InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime, 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you'd like. Legalize drunk driving. That's what Jeffrey Tucker is saying over at liberty.me. Now, to be fair, it's not the first time a liberty-minded person has advocated for this. It's a great clickbait kind of a headline.
Yes.
And, of course, Jeffrey Tucker's a fine guy to, you know, persuade people on this point. But actually, Tucker cites Radley Balco in the article, and we've not gotten to that point in it yet, because obviously
Radley Balco being the author of The Rise of the Warrior Cop.
That's correct. And the I believe he's working for the – wasn't it the Post, Washington Post, I think?
It sounds right.
So I want to get in a little bit deeper into some of the reasons here, but we've got Casper on the line, and Casper – has said he thinks that drunk driving laws need to be strictly enforced. Now, we actually had a former cop call earlier, and I have to apologize because I jumped to a conclusion about the cop that called earlier. I thought that he would have been on board for total support enforcement of DUI, but he actually didn't support DUI checkpoints, among other things. And so, like, we ended up agreeing with quite a bit on the cop.
Yes.
But Casper says strict enforcement is what he wants to see happen. Casper, you're back on Free Talk Live with Ian and Daryl.
Yes.
What do you envision? What are they not doing now with enforcing DUI that you feel like they should be doing?
Well, I think they're underfunded all over. They probably don't have enough money to have special trained cops to set up checkpoints and you know, that probably not enough police to do this. But
so have you ever seen a DUI checkpoint before there in Clifton, New Jersey?
Yeah, I've seen them. Okay. You know,
so you're saying there's not enough. You're saying there needs to be more funding for more checkpoints.
Oh, sure, definitely. Yeah. I mean, look, who takes the brunt of all this? Pedestrians and cyclists.
Well, no, we take the brunt of the checkpoints because that is a huge hassle. I mean, the average person trying to get from point A to point B, having to go through one of these checkpoints, that's taking the brunt of it, and that really sucks. But I see what you're saying. You're upset because some drunk drivers will get into an accident.
Well, yeah, sure.
What about sleepy drivers?
Yes, in California, around maybe 4 or 5 years ago, a woman wiped out 3 cyclists in about maybe a couple of seconds. 3 in a row, she was changing her tape recorder on her car. She was distracted for maybe a second, and it took her eyes off the road, veered to the right, and 3 cyclists.
Let's just ban driving. No, nobody gets to have a car because some people have accidents.
How about banning eating while driving, Casper? What do you think about that one?
To the extent that if it's distracting, yes, but if it's not, look.
So what you're saying is you could eat without being distracted, right, Casper?
No, I'm just saying if.
Have you ever eaten behind the wheel?
Yeah, I drive.
Yeah, I bet you have.
Have you ever driven with your knees? I've done that while munching on like a Big
Mac. That's distracting. I mean, let's be reasonable. Look,
you've been so reasonable so far. So, Casper, you want to see more DUI checkpoints? Now, I mean, how often would you say is too often? I mean, is it like, you know, if you were just driving to work in the morning on a daily basis, would you like to go through a DUI checkpoint?
Use them when they're going to be needed, like on a Friday night.
You don't think people drive to work 3 sheets to the wind?
No, when they're needed the most, you know.
What makes you think that it's more likely that there's a drunk driver on the roads on Friday?
Well, because they got paid, they're out drinking, whatever they came home from.
Alcoholics are drinking all day, every day, man.
Yep.
They're drinking constantly.
Look, whenever they could catch him, they should catch him.
So, in the morning, on the way to work, you just get stopped by a DUI checkpoint.
I don't think you're drinking then. I mean, usually it's going to be at night, especially late at night.
All right. How about on the way home from work? You get stopped at a DUI checkpoint every single day.
Friday.
What about every day, though? I mean, there's people drinking every day. They're going from work to the bar, going from the bar to the house.
Whatever they can do. Look,
so you'd be all right with that, then?
Way of catching them. Hey, I give the cops credit if they can.
So tell me, how far are we going to go with this? I mean, look, all right. So now you've got DUI checkpoints happening 10 times as often as they currently do. Let's say at the checkpoint, do you feel like they're going far enough? I mean, some checkpoints they're just kind of leaning in, grabbing some identification from the people, maybe exchanging a few words with them, trying to determine if they are drunk. Should everybody at the checkpoint, you know, be asked to get out and go through the actual DUI tests? Because that's the only way to know for sure, right?
No, leave it up to the policeman. He's been experienced.
Up to the police.
And the test, just for the record, Ian, the test does not test whether or not you are intoxicated. It tests whether or not your cognitive functions are impaired.
Yeah.
And it's very similar to the concussion test.
Mm-hmm.
Now, look, they have a baseline. So what are they going to do? They have to draw a line somewhere. There has to be a baseline, something they can go for.
But you don't believe in a baseline because you said leave it up to the officer. You said leave it to the individual officer.
So should everybody blow into the little breath device? Just do that.
Good question. Yeah, what do you think,
Casper? Because then that's not up to interpretation.
Well, you know, look, the police have a lot of discretion that they have at their use, so they could use whatever they feel is needed.
Well, no, that's a cop-out. We're not asking you. No. That's a cop-out. I'm not asking you what, you know, the police feel is needed. I'm asking you what Casper thinks, because you said you think it should be strict enforcement. And Daryl asked you a fair question, and you didn't answer it.
Well, look, Lord knows how many people are hit and runs that have a little bit of drinking.
Did you hear the question that you were asked?
I don't think he heard the question. Casper, do you think that everybody that goes through a DUI checkpoint should have to breathe into the breathalyzer, because that is in no way subjective?
That's a waste of time.
So is the DUI checkpoint.
Yeah. Thanks for the call, Casper. It sounds like you're not so strict after all, and that's okay. That's good. I'm glad that even Casper has his limits. He's not willing to get out of the car. He's not willing to even blow into a little tube.
Right, because he's not drunk. Just only the drunk people should have to blow into the little tube. And the cops should use their discretion, but they're not cracking down hard enough. which means that it sounds like he wants them to not use discretion unless it's against him.
It's a pretty typical viewpoint, right? Like, enforce on everybody else, leave me alone.
Right.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Will is in Atlantic City listening to WPG. Hey, Will.
Hi. Yeah, I don't know if you guys know about this hero campaign.
No.
I think it might be national.
What is it?
Oh, well, we have it around here. You know, be a hero. Don't let your friends drive drunk, or, you know, don't let your friends drink and drive. And it started out with, because this guy's son was killed in an accident with a drunk driver. And so what happened was the driver who got in the accident with him was actually taken in. He was charged with driving under the influence. And then some friend of his came and bailed him out of jail. And he got back in his car, drove, and got in an accident. And, you know, this fellow's son was killed in the accident.
Okay.
And so the parents, what they wanted to do was make a law that if you bail someone out, you're responsible for their actions after that point.
Oh, my God.
Even if you take them home and get them into their house and leave, and they get out of their house and they get back in their car, and then they get into an accident or cause some damage or injure someone, you are still responsible for what they did because you bailed them out.
For how long of a time period?
Well, I'm not sure.
For 8 hours? For like 12, 16, 24?
Yeah, I think maybe the rest of that day or that date. I'm not certain.
So this is something that's being proposed now, or is it off the table? Is this old news? Like, how fresh is this?
Yeah, no, it was proposed, and then it was challenged in the court. It was passed, but it was challenged in the court by some freedom-loving people.
Okay.
And it said, you know, hey, why should the friend or relative be responsible for this? And it was struck down. So the hero campaign changed. It didn't go away, but they changed it to, you know, find someone to drive for you if you've been drinking so that you don't drink and drive. But the real issue is not drinking and driving. This 0.08%, this arbitrary number, because if you look at the statistics, it's really repeat offenders. It's not the casual drinker who causes accidents.
Yeah, that's a good point. Will, good call tonight. Fascinating stuff. New Jersey. Wow. Wow, New Jersey. 855-453.
If I needed another reason to avoid New Jersey.
Yeah. Oh, my God. So to hold someone responsible for the actions of the person they bailed out of jail. Thank goodness that one got overturned.
Yeah.
855-450-FREE, but it's probably not too long before somebody tries it again somewhere else.
Yeah, they'll tweak the wording a little bit. Right.
855-450-3733. You can take control here. This is the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. Legalize drunk driving? What do you think? Free Talk Live. You take control.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another micro-loan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, January 9th, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,211, silver at $16.44, and Bitcoin is trading around $297.96. Today's precious metal price is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. With civil unrest occurring all across the country, being food secure has never been more important. Visit eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, on Thursday, a bill to approve the construction of the Keystone XL oil pipeline passed another barrier in the Senate. The Senate Energy Committee approved the measure with a 13-9 vote. The bill will go before the full Senate next week, while the House of Representatives is scheduled to vote on Friday. A federal judge in California has overturned a ban on the sale of controversial foie gras, duck or goose liver, which has been fattened through force feeding. Foie gras involves deliberately fattening the animals by force feeding corn through a feeding tube. U.S. District Judge Stephen V. Wilson permanently blocked the state attorney general from enforcing a law which banned the practice. Judge Wilson made his decision based on the argument that the federal government's authority trumps the state's. Activists from across the political spectrum are organizing a global day of action against the use of torture on January 31st. In response to a lack of media coverage and action from politicians following the release of the Senate report on CIA torture, a number of organizations are calling for rallies and protests across the globe to stand in solidarity with victims of torture. The Anti-Media, the Conscious Resistance Network, the Solutions Institute, and a growing list of activist groups and media outlets are joining the calls for action. Several cities are planning on hosting mock waterboarding and force-feeding presentations. Today's broadcast of Liberty Beat is made possible by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Did you know you can support the Liberty Beat when shopping on Amazon.com? Just log into your account after clicking our Amazon affiliate link at libertybeat.com/Amazon. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 9th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. The accused operator of the Deep Web Silk Road Marketplace is set to go to trial. Catherine Bleich has this Liberty Beat special report.
Many of you know that in late 2013, the online Bitcoin black market, known as the Silk Road, was shut down. The alleged founder, Ross Ulbricht, was arrested and charged with conspiracy to traffic drugs, launder money, and even murder for hire in the state of Maryland. This month, he will go on trial for many of these charges in the state of New York. The Liberty Beat is pleased to announce that we will be there to report live from the courtroom the entire first week. With a generous donation hearing from Roger Ver, also known as the Bitcoin Jesus, the Liberty Beat's Derek Bros is one of several activists who have been funded to travel to New York to serve as our eyes and ears. We hope to also send the Liberty Beat's founder and editor-in-chief, John Bush. The two plan to work in tandem as they live blog the courtroom actions, write narrative pieces, interview key people, and create audio media. Help us send our amazing team into the belly of the beast to document this historic trial by visiting thelibertybeat.com/support. You can expect the mainstream media to only paint a small part of the picture. Let the Liberty Beat bring you the truth. To learn more about Ross and his case, visit freeross.org.
Today's edition of the Liberty Beat is sponsored by My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at mymagicmud.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your message or product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more, visit libertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 9th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
The total loser's corpse contained no traces of drugs or alcohol, and a superstitious Delta Airlines adds busty mermaids to its plane noses. My friend, you look like you are in need of the world's finest internet news summaries. Please come in and warm yourself by the fire of knowledge. This is the Onion Week in Review. A new law passed in Colorado this week will allow residents with a doctor's prescription to purchase medicinal fireworks, saying that those in need of stargazers, firecrackers, and Galleria highlights now need only obtain a doctor's prescription. State officials expressed hope that the law would ease the suffering of those in need of huge, dazzling explosions. And in this week's op-ed pages, a man notes that, like it or not, we all die, then get dug up and molested. In other news, white male privilege is squandered on a job at Best Buy, and a local TCBY has missed the past two logo changes. Well, that's it for now. Goodbyes are bittersweet, my love, so I'll only tell you, for more, keep checking theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition. Take control of the airwaves here, toll free, 855-450-FREE. More coming up on drunk driving. Jeffrey Tucker over at liberty.me is saying legalize it. We'll give you some more of his rationale in a moment because we've really only gotten through about half of the piece. We got overwhelmed with your calls and thoughts, and I do want to get through the rest of it, so hopefully we'll get a chance to do that. With you in studio tonight, it's me, Ian.
And Daryl.
Don't forget, you can join us online at freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features you'll find there. Those other talk show hosts charge you for their websites, and ours is free. So again, that's freetalklive.com. But first, let's go to Brett. He is on the line, because you don't have to talk about what we're talking about here on Free Talk Live. Brett, you're on via Skype.
Yep. How you guys doing tonight?
Hey, and you're in Baltimore,
right?
Good, man. Go ahead, sir.
It sort of relates to what you guys were talking about. It's about the new movie, Neil Blomkamp's new movie, Chappie, which have you guys heard about it?
I had not heard of it prior to your phone call, but given that we did have the extended news break there, both Daryl and I did pull up the trailer here in the studio. For our listeners that have not seen it or not aware of it, can you summarize?
So it's basically about the world's first robotic police force in what seems like South Africa, because that's usually where Neil Blomkamp's movies are set.
Yeah, it's like got that South African music group in it whose name I don't remember.
Die Antwoord.
Die Antwoord, yeah. That's right.
Yeah, it's like Afrikaans for some philosophical thing. But and I don't know what the main character is, but he's like he creates a self-aware, conscious robot from the scrap of this robotic police force. Mm. And the government comes down and tries to kill this robotic, this conscious robot. And you can really get a real police brutality feel from it, is what I'm seeing.
So what was the, what's the thrust of your call? Did you just want to know what we thought of the trailer? Or
yeah, I was wondering what you guys thought about something like that, like a robotic police force, and it's just like the way the media is now, it's really picking up in what seems like pop culture.
Well, I mean, certainly Terminator has been around for a long time. I mean,
true.
When you say this is picking up in pop culture, you mean like they redid RoboCop, which again was originally done in the mid-1980s.
Well, there have been a lot of developments over the last 10 years mm-hmm. on creating AI.
In robotics, too.
In robotics.
Yeah, sure.
And some of that is mixing over into pop culture because you have Asimo, which is
the Sony robot.
Honda.
Oh, that's Honda.
It's the robot created by Honda. And President Obama has actually gone and met Asimo. And Asimo has, you know, like played soccer with the president.
Sure. And you know that the police have the robot bomb detecting things or whatever, the bomb.
Right, right. And there was a video that I think it went viral from the Boston. I don't think it was MIT, but it was, you know, some Boston robotics company that made this big, giant, like, bull sort of robot thing that it runs, and
it can run.
You try to knock it off balance, it steadies itself.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about, and I suspect the company is iRobot, which is the company that makes the vacuum cleaning robots as well. So that's one of the difficulties of being, and I think it's an interesting topic, Brett, because it brings up sort of the larger discussion here.
Yeah.
This company, they make the little vacuum cleaner. It's cute. It bumps around and it, like, picks things up, and you can put little googly eyes on it and whatever. It's cute. But at the same time, everybody who buys one of those vacuum cleaning robots is supporting the same company that's doing business with the federal government to make robots that will kill people.
Right.
So, like, it's hard. Like, if you love science and technology and you're excited about robotics, you know, what companies can you get behind that aren't actually in bed with the government in some way?
Right. So it's akin to, you know, saying that everyone who buys an airplane ticket from a company that uses Boeing is supporting the war machine, because Boeing, in addition to making commercial airliners, they make things for the U.S. government. So, you know, You kind of have to draw the line somewhere of, you know, commercial viability, or just, you know, like, I'm not going to do business with anyone because that requires me walking on a public sidewalk that I don't think should exist, driving down a government road,
sure,
putting fuel in my car, paying a fuel tax, and I don't like taxes, so I'm just going to live in the middle of nowhere and never communicate with another human being.
So I don't pay close attention, Brett. You said that you think that robots, specifically military or police-style robots, are being put into pop culture more often these days?
Well, just the overall, like, theme of, like, the police being not the stereotypical good guy in all these things, but you're still seeing that pop up all over the place. But going to the point of, you guys are talking about how you can't find something that's, like, sort of libertarian pure, of, like, you can't find something that's not inside the spiderweb relationship of the state and corporate powers. Mm-hmm. It's like Jeffrey Tucker was saying, you got to find ways to circumvent it and find ways around it instead of trying to, like, work through it.
Thank you, Brett, for the call. Are you going to go see that movie, by the way?
Oh, yeah.
It looks pretty good. I'd say that I'd check it out.
Yeah. I'm not going to go to the movie theater to watch it.
No, I don't think I would either, necessarily.
Scared of North Korea.
Thanks for the call, Brett. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So, yeah, if you want to talk about robots and the police, because we were talking about the police in regards to drunk driving enforcement, and it seems like it's inevitable, right? Like that as long as governments exist, when robots come into their own, and we're getting there, I mean, they're getting pretty amazing already. Then, you know, in 10 more years, how long is it going to be before they've got robot assistants? They've got dogs already, so how long before a robot? They still have the bomb robots, I guess, already, but I guess a more, like, humanoid style, like this is what they showed in this movie.
So I don't know. It is interesting, but it also brings up the sort of larger question of, you know, should these machines that would not then be able to sort of have the autonomy of making a decision,
mm-hmm.
Should they be doing jobs that requires, you know, nuance?
Well, the people in the state love the idea of non-thinking police officers. I mean, that's why some police departments have actually IQ limits if your officer possible, you know, job applicants or whatever, if they test too high on an IQ test. I think it was New London, Connecticut that actually made the news for this years ago for actually having a policy to where if somebody was over 120 IQ that they were not allowed to become a police officer. They don't want officers thinking independently. They want them following arbitrary rules.
Right, but they always say you have discretion.
They do.
You have discretion. But yet, you know, if you wind up putting a robot in the job, the robot isn't going to use discretion because the robot doesn't understand discretion.
Which is why I suspect a lot of people inside the state would support having these mindless automatons out there on the streets enforcing their statutes. Your calls are welcome. The toll-free
number. So why not have robot judges?
Don't give them ideas, Daryl. 855-450-FREE. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. We'll go to Bob. He's listening in Atlanta. Bob, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi. So I basically want to talk about the idiot who thinks that it's a good idea to legalize drunk driving. And I actually have a lot of experience from like responding to drunk driving car crashes and stuff like that.
Are you a paramedic?
And yes.
Okay.
And I, you know, just in my day-to-day job, I've seen not even driving ambulances and stuff like that. I've actually seen fatal car crashes involving, you know, multiple fatalities of one stupid drunk idiot woman and three children who all died, and then like three who were severely injured and almost died, mm-hmm. and then two adults who were just pretty badly injured.
No doubt. I mean, there's terrible stories about people drinking and driving and the horrible dangers that it puts people in. But aren't you sort of acknowledging that the laws aren't working?
Well, what I'm acknowledging is that nothing that we can't do anything to stop, you know, drunk driving. But what we can do is we can say, oh, this person, you know, drove drunk and they killed five people and they're alive. But because drunk driving is legal, we can't do anything about it. Sorry. No,
we're not saying you can't do anything about it. Hang on, Bob. We can bring it back here in a moment. I understand this is an emotionally charged issue. We'll get into it. 855-450-FREE. What could be done without DUI laws?
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power, a gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was
kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you'd like. Toll free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features waiting for you. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. And with you tonight, Ian here.
And Daryl.
Don't forget, we've got coffee waiting for you. Free coffee. You get an entire pound just for paying the shipping cost over at coffee.freetalklive.com. It's great coffee from BuzzBox. It's shade-grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica. You can go and get hooked up for coffee.freetalklive.com. And one thing they're doing at BuzzBox is very unique, is a portion of the profits on each pound of coffee are going towards microloans through kiva.org. So for every 10 listeners that signs up at coffee.freetalklive.com, we can fund out one new microloan every single month, which is amazing to me. Coffee.freetalklive.com is where you can go grab your first pound free. You can cancel your subscription at any time, but if you stay on board, you'll receive more coffee at the frequency that you would like to receive it and in the amount that you'd prefer and in the flavor that you like. So you customize all those things. Coffee.freetalklive.com. As we go back to Bob, listening in Atlanta, Georgia. Now, Bob, can you kind of recap what you were saying a moment ago?
Okay. Do you want me to say the story again, or do you want me just to say that I believe DUIs are stupid?
Well, whatever. I mean, whatever you think's important to get out.
Well,
you work on an ambulance, and you've seen horrible things with DUI, and think that the laws are necessary, even though it's clearly the case that they're not stopping people from drunk driving.
I don't believe in sobriety checkpoints. I believe that people should be able to enforce the laws and be able to see. It should be the police discretion as far as, no, you do not have the right to stop me from doing what I have to do in my day-to-day life with your stupid checkpoint. That should be against the law. What should be legalized is, you know, you have to have, like, everything, just like, you know, the age of consent and all these other things. There has to be some kind of, you know, a random arbitrary fact and figure, you know, like 0.08. There are medical reasons why 0.08 is the law, because they're like peripheral vision and all that stuff.
But wait, no, it was 0.1 previously. How come there were medical reasons why it was 0.08 when it used to be 0.1?
Well, I don't really know that exact thing, but
it's BS, you know, is right. Why. And as was pointed out by the caller earlier, there are different people who have different levels of tolerance regarding alcohol, different body weights and things like that, and, you know, tolerance levels, etc. And so somebody who's a 0.08 may drive better than another person who's a 0.06 or something.
Yeah, but, you know, when you are dealing with public roads, when you are dealing with, you can do whatever you want on your own private land. I can get drunk
on my, if I had 10 acres, I could get drunk and go four-wheeling, and I wouldn't catch a DUI for that. That's not going to happen. But what is going to happen if I'm driving a vehicle that requires a licensing registration, or I'm on a public road and I'm driving and I'm an idiot and I'm causing problems, and a cop can tell that I'm causing problems, and I end up, say, I don't even end up killing people, but because I'm an idiot and I'm driving, you know, and I happen to have a .08 or even a .14.
Why does it matter if there's alcohol in your body or if you're tired? I mean, Daryl, we haven't gotten to the numbers yet, but you pulled up some statistics.
Yeah, on average, there are 100,000 police-reported crashes as a direct result of driver fatigue.
That's a lot.
You know, and I've dealt with quadriplegics that were in that situation because the fellow sleeps at the wheel. And there are laws that state, sorry, buddy, if you're going to endanger other people, you don't have the right to drive on a public road where you haven't slept for 36 hours or whatever.
So why not just enforce the – I mean, why do you need to have an extra criminal charge?
I'm in trouble.
Hold on. Why do you have to have an extra criminal charge? Why not just enforce reckless driving laws? What does it matter if the person is, you know, had a couple beers versus hasn't slept enough? What is the difference?
I believe that if you're going to be stupid enough to drive around without sleeping for a day and a half, and you can't do it, there should be consequences as far as risking yourself. You know.
But that's not answering the question.
You're not answering my question. Can you rephrase it, Daryl? Maybe I'm having a tough time getting through.
Instead of having extra charges of you were reckless driving plus you had alcohol in your system, or you were reckless driving plus we've determined that you haven't slept enough, or you were reckless driving just because you don't know how to operate a car, why not just have reckless driving? Why have the extra charge of DUI or drowsy? Why not just enforce the reckless driving statutes?
Okay, and I'm going to say this to you. As far as reckless driving and being tired and all that stuff, I feel that you should have the charges. You should have, you know, the DUI charge, for example. Let's just take that because that's simpler to deal with starting off. I'd rather have DUI charges kept on and tacked on because, one, you know what the hell you're doing. You know that if you get drunk, you're going to be bad at driving compared to how you normally are. So, you know, there are people that can drive better at a .20 than others. You know, I can drive better at a .20 because I have high alcohol tolerance, but I don't drive drunk. I know that if I am going to drive drunk, there's a higher risk of killing someone, and there's no
point. But you also know that you should also know that if you're tired. So do you then support
or if the road is wet because it's been snowing or raining and you're driving 5 miles over the limit, you've got bald tires, you know, you're still driving recklessly.
Bob, do you support creating laws for driving while tired? Do you want to have some sort of test?
They already have laws. They already have laws against that.
They have laws, they just don't have a test.
No.
So would you support that a test be if somebody's got a little sleep in their eye, maybe?
I don't support any of these stupid tests where someone says, you know, I don't support any DUI checkpoints. I don't support any of that stuff. I'm a libertarian. What I do expect, though, is that the laws be made so that people aren't, you know, so that stupidity as far as, you know, oh, I admitted that I haven't slept in 36 hours and I fell asleep at the wheel knowing that I could keep my eyes open, but I'm going to fall asleep while driving. Okay, well, if you kill someone else, then you should not only be charged with reckless endangerment, you should be charged with, you know, you can't really charge someone with DUI or something like that, or driving while sleeping, because that's going to go down a really bad path as far as driving while sleeping. So that's why I don't think this guy was drowsy. And then so because they do offer that whole officer's discretion thing, well, that guy was tired, I could tell. But meanwhile, no, I'm not tired. I just, you know, I look tired because I have an allergy or something like that.
Well, so wouldn't you say, though, it's more dangerous to drive while tired than to drive after two beers?
Yeah, I completely agree. And that's why I think that if there was some concrete way where they could, you know, do a scan on your face and with 100% sureness, they could say, oh, yeah, I'm absolutely positive that this guy hasn't slept in 48 hours. You know, in that case, I'd be like, you're an idiot. And I really don't think that you have the right to be on a public road and endanger everyone else because you decided you wanted to go out
Bob, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So it sounds like if there were some sort of scan that could determine tiredness, Bob, the self-proclaimed libertarian caller of the night, is in support of that.
But no sleepy checkpoints, no DUI checkpoints.
Yeah, just.
But somehow enforce the scanner things.
So anytime you get pulled over, you can pull out the sleepy face scanner and possibly catch an extra criminal charge. 855-450-FREE. Doesn't sound very libertarian to me. More on the way. It's Free Talk Live.
I lost 18 pounds in just 4 days. Hi, I'm James Zetta. If you're like me, you've already tried and failed at many diet and weight loss plans. The 18 and 4 weight loss plan requires no exercising, no diet pills or additives, no laxatives, no meal replacements, and no diet drinks. The 18 and 4 program is crystal clear with a day-to-day, step-by-step, and meal-to-meal guide. If you're not satisfied with your results, I will give you my 30-day full money-back guarantee. Go to 18and4.com. That's the number 18, I-N, the number 4.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
After decades of searching the cosmos, today NASA announced that what it was really looking for was right here on planet Earth all along.
For years, we've foolishly chased after comets, moons, and stars. Outer space may be beautiful, but it's not as beautiful as the smile of a child, nor as sublime as a good bottle of wine shared among friends. Our search ends where it began, here on this big blue marble.
Astronomers say that while their telescopes were pointing at Mars, they never even noticed the planet that was right in front of them. NASA now plans to appreciate what they already have. The agency's latest report, entitled Wonder is Everywhere, Finding the Beauty in the Everyday, calls for further study of the little things that truly give life meaning.
Warm rain on a summer day, the smell of pine trees, touching the worn paper of your favorite book, that's what's always made us happy. Not some asteroid a million miles away.
This is the Onion News Network.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We'll be right back.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever you'd like toll-free here. 855-450-FREE. That is a toll-free number. You may dial it at any point in regards to whatever topic you'd like to discuss. The overarching discussion tonight has been about DUI, driving while allegedly drunk. Should it be legal? That's what Jeffrey Tucker is saying over at liberty.me. And we're going to take some more of your calls here, but there's actually more from the story where he cites another author in regards to some of the points, Radley Balco, like some points as to why he thinks drunk driving should be legal. I'll share a little more of that with you here in moments, and you're welcome to share your thoughts with us. With you tonight, it's Ian here.
And Daryl.
Daryl is the host of his own show, which is Peace, Love, Liberty Radio. It is a podcast done thrice weekly at this point.
Yes.
And you also do 7 days a week, a five-minute long news package.
Yes, I've been doing that since February, so quickly approaching 1 year.
It's very exciting.
With only a three-day absence, as I was incarcerated in the Cheshire County House of Corrections for refusal to pay an unjust fine.
So it wasn't that you chose to not do the show. They chose to put you in jail. So
they chose to put me in jail, and I could not find a replacement.
Go to fpp.cc. You can read more of Daryl there. But if you want to get his audio shows, go to fppradio.com, and you can get a lot more of Daryl every single day. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. We've got Matthew. He's on the line calling from Austin, Texas, listening or not listening to you, but on Skype. Go ahead, Matthew.
Hi.
Hey, you're on the air.
I was calling about the DUI discussion. You had asked before you went to break in the last segment, what would we do without DUI laws? And that kind of perked me up there. The short answer, I think, is go on with our lives and not have as many people incarcerated and put through the system and have money extracted from them and prop up an entire industry of lawyers who are there to basically just kind of see you through to the end and try to keep them from getting as more money, which they then take for themselves.
Yeah, that's a great point. This the whole DUI thing is really a major moneymaker for the attorney industry, more so than anything else. And of course, all the, you know, the different devices, like the, what's the thing that they put in your car that checks your breath? It's like a little in-car.
Oh yeah, I know the thing. The interlock device.
Interlock, that's what it's called. Ignition interlock.
And everybody that I know that has ever had one, they always come up with a pet name for their interlock device. So, like, I've got to go kiss Henry before I can drive.
So Mothers Against Drunk Driving actually advocates having those in all cars by law.
So crazy.
What?
Those people are crazy. At least I'm glad to hear that the people who've called the show tonight who have been in support of DUI laws, most of them have not been in favor of maximum enforcement. Like,
checkpoints. They also don't support the checkpoints, random, you know, pull people over for random things, and then, oh, by the way, have you been drinking?
But yeah, there's a lot of attorneys who, as you described, they will take $3,000, $5,000 from you basically to hold your hand through a plea deal process.
And then tell you, and then they say, oh, we really tried hard. You're really lucky, though, that you only had to pay $10,000. You could have had to pay $20,000 or $25,000. So, you got off easy, kid. Well, by the way, my fee will be, $4,000, $5,000 as well.
Right. I don't know what the standard first-time DUI offense fines are like across the country. I imagine they vary widely.
Yes.
But I do know that it's quite inconvenient for people, and then there's all kinds of money that they have to shell out, not just to the state, but also to the whichever company installs the ignition interlock in their car.
And then in some states, they have all of these added fees on top of the fine. I was listening to one of the more popular radio attorney guys, and he was saying he got pulled over for something in California. The cop hands him a $24 ticket, and he was like, oh, it's just $24. Cop says, wait till you see the fees. The $24 ticket wound up being $142 after all of these fees that were added on.
Yeah, that sounds like the state. You know what? Like we were saying before, if these people who are doing the enforcing actually cared about their fellow man, they would be taking them home. They'd be giving them a ride, or they'd be accompanying them and sort of following them home. And that would be a more service-oriented viewpoint. But this is just plain enforcement, and clearly it's not working because, as was pointed out, there's a lot of repeat offenders. A lot of times when somebody gets popped for a DUI, it's number 2, 3, 4, 5. And so clearly the punishment mentality is not actually effective.
I remember when I was living in Pennsylvania, there was a story about a guy who was charged with his 25th DUI.
Wow.
Had a suspended license for about 25 years. Showed up to the hearing
drunk.
The guy that drove him there was also drunk. And look, so what did they do? They suspended his license for 30 more years.
Wow.
This is what it comes down to with DWI laws. They're new. In our country's history, they have not existed prior to the early 1980s, maybe late 1970s. I'm not sure of the exact year, but people drove drunk all the time. And now there's laws against it, and they still do it. And it's turned into one of the biggest businesses for the state and the legal system that's grown up around it. The answer is, if you're going to discourage people from driving drunk, not to have this huge witch hunt of officers out in a predatory fashion, looking for drunk drivers and trying to use it as people who've even had one beer getting the book thrown at them in certain cases. What we need to do is say, if you get caught driving drunk, the book gets thrown at you. That's what's going to discourage people, or not have the laws at all. If people drive drunk, then they should have to pay restitution to their victims and their victims' family. The officers should be driving them home. That's what they used to do, and society was better. That's all I have.
I'm with you. Thanks, Matthew. Good call. Toll-free number, I'd say he nailed it, actually, 855-450-FREE. But you may have something to add to the discussion, like Jose in Jacksonville, Alabama, listening to WDNG. Hello, Jose.
Hello.
Hey there.
Glad to join the conversation. And I'm going to switch back to the other topic on the U.S. Supreme Court decision, 8-1. It was an 8-1 vote to allow police officers to get away with pulling you over, even though they do not have a legal basis to do that. So think about this. We're taught, since we're kids, we hear this thing, ignorance of the law is no excuse. The police say that, the prosecutor say that, the judge say that. We're supposed to be the ignorant ones, but yet ignorance of the law is no excuse. Yet police officers who are trained in law enforcement have now been given a double standard by the U.S. Supreme Court, saying that they can have reasonable ignorance.
Mm-hmm.
And they're the ones that are trained in the law. So here's the most serious thing that I don't think a lot of people are thinking about. This opens a can of worms when it comes to another legal phrase called fruit of the poisonous tree.
Yes, it does.
Okay, so now the Supreme Court has basically said, cops, you can go ahead and claim ignorance anytime you seize evidence unlawfully, or anytime you arrest somebody unlawfully, or anytime you pull somebody unlawfully. I didn't know. Yeah. I discussed this with a lawyer friend of mine. He says, well, now the burden is going to be on the accused to get their lawyer to pull out the records of training on this police officer, to show the court, the jury, or whatever, that this officer was not ignorant, that he's committing perjury.
Yeah, it's going to be a very, very difficult burden. You're absolutely right, Jose. Great call. Thanks for making it tonight. I do appreciate it. What he referenced was the fruit of the poisonous tree, which means that it used to mean, until this recent case, I think, it used to mean that if the police got evidence in a manner that was illegal, that all the evidence after that point that, you know, was garnered through the illegality is not admissible. And now if the cop claims, well, I didn't know that was illegal, and that's going to be allowed in court, that's going to be a huge change for the worse. 855-450-FREE. You take control here. This is Free Talk Live's Live Saturday Show.
It's the end of year clearance sale at Lumber Liquidators. We'd rather sell it than count it. So every floor and every store is on sale, and it all must go. Get incredible deals on first quality flooring from just 35 cents a square foot. Beautiful 3/4 inch pre-finished solid hardwood is just $179. Save even more on all liquidation clearance and closeouts. If it's in stock, it's on sale, and pay no interest until January 2017. Don't miss these end of year deals on over 400 floors. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Times are different than they were when GEICO started saving people money over 75 years ago. Everybody takes photos of their food nowadays. You can bet none of us kids would snap pictures of Mom's tuna casserole surprise. To this day, we don't know what the surprise was, nor do we want to. We didn't always have tasty food, but we always had great car insurance with GEICO.
GEICO, saving people money on car insurance for over 75 years.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right, that's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free and take control of the airwaves. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you. We includes me, Ian.
And Daryl.
And, of course, you can join us over at freetalklive.com. And if you like the show and you like what we're doing on Free Talk Live, then please get behind the show for $5 a month. And you can do it with any major credit card. You can use Visa or MasterCard right on our website. And you can use PayPal for all those other cards or at your convenience, you know, whichever card works best for you at amp.freetalklive.com. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. The idea is that we will take the $5 We'll combine it with other people's $5, and we'll buy advertising for Free Talk Live to promote the show to other talk radio stations. We're on over 150 talk radio stations as of now. We could have double that number fairly easily. It's just a matter of making people aware that we exist. And so some of the AMP dollars goes to advertising. Some of it goes to you, Daryl. You're doing affiliate relations for the show, so you're calling 5 days a week, calling radio stations, pitching the show to them. I do that work as well. And so I don't collect a paycheck for it because it's part of my job. But that's what the AMP dollars are going towards. Some of them send us to industry conventions where we can schmooze it up with the bigwigs and talk radio. Some of the rest of the money goes sometimes to buying a radio station some satellite equipment if they need some hardware to get us on the air. So basically whatever we can do to get more listeners to Free Talk Live and spread the ideas of freedom, or at least, get new people exposed to these concepts. That's what the AMP program's about. And you get perks. You get the access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only Facebook group, and more, the AMP-only podcast, which doesn't have the commercial load the regular podcast does. So go and check it out at amp.freetalklive.com. Let's talk to Slim. He's in our very own Keene, New Hampshire area, listening to WKBK. Hey, Slim.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Good,
great topic tonight.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for what you do.
Of course. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, the DUI checkpoints, it's totally unconstitutional as far as I'm concerned. And one time back in February of 1967, I got pulled over by the Lexington, Massachusetts police. I didn't have a leg under me. They drove me home.
Wow, and this is when, 77?
It should be. 67.
67, okay.
Back in the old days when life was good.
That's an amazing. Now, when they drove you home, were they courteous to you? Do you remember anything from the incident?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah, they don't like that way anymore.
That's the way things should be. And these DUI checkpoints, they're ridiculous, for God's sake. This is supposed to be a free country.
Supposed to be.
Yeah, I don't think it was ever in our lifetime, Slim, or necessarily in anyone's. But it would be a nice thing if we did have freedom. That'd be pretty cool.
Yeah.
Anything else you want to share tonight?
No, and just thanks again for what you guys do.
Thanks for the story, man. I appreciate the call tonight. Let's continue. 855-450-FREE. We've got... W is calling from Bozeman. You're on Free Talk Live. W.
Hey, guys. Good evening.
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
Well, I got a DUI in a small town out here in Montana, and it was kind of silly because we see these cops, they just circle the block at the bar. There's, like, not very many people in the smaller town. So they just circle around the block and probably saw me stumbling out kind of a little bit from the bar, and then I got in my truck, and I was fine, and drove to where I was going just fine and pulled actually into the motel where I was staying, and then I seen the lights behind me, and I get out, and I'm like, right there. My hotel room's right there, my motel room. He could have easily, in a small town, just gone like, hey, you know what? Just get in there and don't do this again, you know? But now he throws the book at me, whatever, and I go to see the judge the following days. And I told the judge, I go, listen, I'll plead guilty if I can have one of those licenses that allows me to go to work. And he said, well, that's fine. Yes, I'll do that. Mm-hmm. And I go, fine, great. So I pled guilty. And next thing you know, I went to go get my license. There, go, no, mandatory 6 months. You cannot have a license. I was like, wait a minute. The judge told me that he was going to do this. Well, he can recommend it.
Oh,
but he knew damn well.
Surprise.
Yeah, I was pretty pissed about that.
Yeah, well, they got you where they can basically do anything they want to you, and so if they tell you a lie, then it's not like you can sue them. You know?
Right. I had a situation one time when I got pulled over. The cop verbally told me one date for the court hearing, wrote on the ticket another date.
Oh, boy.
I was on vacation during the date that was written on the ticket. I would not have been on vacation the date that he verbally told me. And long story short, I cannot go to South Carolina.
You got a warrant.
Yes.
Wow, I didn't realize that part of the story. I knew that you had problems in South Carolina. I didn't know that level of detail.
That's
interesting. W, anything else you want to share?
No, just keep up the good work.
Thanks for the call, man. I appreciate that. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Yeah, if a judge or a cop lies or gives you, or just accidentally gives you misinformation.
Right.
You know, sometimes it's just, you know, with bureaucracy, one hand doesn't know what the other hand's doing. So.
Right, and it could have been something to where, you know, he couldn't count to May, and he wrote down four because he thought four was May.
Well, again, a lot of departments, they don't allow the smart officers.
If, you're, yeah.
if your IQ is too high, you will not get the job. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts. We go to John, listening to WIBC in Indianapolis. Hey, John.
Yeah, it's me. I just want to make a comment about the drunk driving.
Yes, sir.
I don't know about everywhere, but in Indiana, they have two laws that actually, on face value, it doesn't look like it, but they actually promote drunk driving.
Oh, really?
And one of them is the PI laws.
The private investigator laws?
No, I meant public intox laws.
Oh, thank you. Okay, gotcha.
But at any rate, a lot of guys...
Let me just explain what you mean by that, because not everybody's been listening for all 3 hours. So the idea being that if there's a law against public intoxication, that dissuades people from walking to the bar, because if they're on foot, you know, maybe they're going to be stopped by the police. Right.
Well, not so much getting to the bar, but getting back home from
the
bar.
That's what I mean. Getting back home. Thank you. Yes.
Yeah. 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 A lot of guys, you know, live real close, and they would have walked if they would be allowed to walk if they thought they were impaired.
Right.
but they don't want to get caught, you know, wobbling down the street.
And what was the other law that encourages drunk driving?
Open containers. Open container law.
Meaning that you can't take a beer from a bar and walk down, you know, walk back to your house while drinking.
Most bars won't let you walk out of their establishment with a beer anyway.
Because of the liquor laws is one of the reasons why.
Right.
Like here in Keene, there's a ridiculous law that actually, you're going to love this. If you want to go outside, now's not a good time of year for this, but during the summer months in New Hampshire when it's pretty nice out, you know, there's a lot of these bars have outdoor seating areas. And you cannot walk from inside the bar with a beer in your hand and take it to the outside seating area. You have to hand the beer to a bar employee, walk out to the seating area, and the bar employee then brings the beer that you handed to them back to you outside. That's just absolutely ludicrous. John, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Let's continue here. We've got your calls and thoughts going to Chris, also listening in Indianapolis to WIBC. Hello, Chris.
Hi, how are you?
Chris, doing great. Go ahead.
Yeah, I'd like to say that I support the DUI laws and the enforcement. I don't approve of the methods that they use as far as DUI checkpoints.
Okay.
Out there just aggressively tailing people and pulling them over for minor things.
Okay.
To garner the probable cause to stop you. People have been taking advantage of the libations since the beginning of time. They do it irresponsibly. Some do it responsibly. I have children on the roads traveling, you know, my loved ones. So I am in support of all the DUI enforcement measures that go on.
So
what? Except checkpoints.
The certain ones I don't are the DUI checkpoints, aggressively following people looking. Mm-hmm. Specifically for the DUIs.
So I'll ask you the same question
and
that I've asked.
I don't also like how the state has become such a proponent of it as far as making money to support the judges and the lawyers and the courts.
So I'll ask you the same question that I've asked other people and have yet to get an answer on. Instead of enforcing the drunk driving laws, because obviously you've said that you don't like the checkpoints, you don't like the way they go about enforcing, why not simply have a reckless driving statute that is enforced? Why have the added charge of driving intoxicated?
I would think that would be fine to streamline things through the courts, because the courts get so bogged down with all these. However, I don't think the state's General Assembly here in Indiana would ever do anything of that nature.
Oh, of course not. I mean, it would be so fascinating to watch this. Thank you, by the way, Chris, for anybody that actually proposed to get rid of DUI laws to watch those hearings. Those would be fun to attend.
That's why you need initiatives.
We'll come back with more. It's Free Talk Live.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Juicy Juice, 100% juice, providing a full serving of fruit in every 4 ounces. Visit us at juicyjuice.com. When it comes to nutrition, kids need both fruits and vegetables every day to stay healthy and grow. For the ideal mix, your kid should have at least 1.5 cups of any veggie or 100% veggie juice, and 1 cup of any fruit or 100% fruit juice a day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From King of the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, January 10th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.52 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,223 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $277. Antiwar.com reports U.S. senators are angrily condemning the Palestinian Authority for its attempt to join the International Criminal Court with a joint statement from several promising a strong response in retaliation. The statement blasts the membership bid as deplorable, counterproductive, and suggests that the U.S. should revoke foreign aid provided to the Palestinians, which makes up some $400 million annually. The U.S. has insisted that Palestine can't be a member because it's not a state, but since they are recognized by the United Nations as a non-member observer state, there is no indication the UN is going to agree with that claim. Israel has been pushing for Congress to cut off aid to the Palestinians to punish them for the move, which means a large portion of Congress will inevitably back the revocation. There is no sign, however, that this is going to scare the Palestinians away from seeking membership.
In the spirit of Motorhome Diaries and Liberty on Tour, I intend to take the message of peace, love, and liberty on the road. During the 104-day trip, I'll be visiting at least 10 cities across the country, speaking to people about the ideas of peace, love, and liberty. To find out more about the tour or to donate, visit tour.fppradio.com. It's tour.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports the FBI and Justice Department prosecutors have recommended bringing criminal charges against former CIA chief David Petraeus for improperly providing classified information to a female Army Reserve officer with whom he was having an affair. The New York Times reported on Friday, citing officials who spoke on the condition of anonymity. The Justice Department investigations focus on whether Petraeus gave the woman, Paula Broadwell, access to his CIA email account and other highly classified information. The Times said officials have recommended felony charges. The recommendations leave U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder with the decision to make on whether to seek an indictment against Petraeus, who quit his CIA post in 2012 after the extramarital affair became publicly known. Petraeus also is one of the leading U.S. military commanders in recent times, having served as commander of American forces in both Iraq and Afghanistan. The Times reported that Petraeus has indicated to the Justice Department that he has no interest in a plea deal that would enable him to avoid a trial. Petraeus said he did not provide classified information to Broadwell, who was writing his biography at the time of the affair. A spokesman for Petraeus said the retired general had no comment, and his lawyer declined to comment.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports the U.S. Supreme Court once again postponed dealing with the issue of same-sex marriage, taking no action on petitions asking the justices to review lower court rulings. The justices met in conference in Washington as a federal appeals court in New Orleans heard arguments on bans on same-sex marriage in Louisiana, Mississippi, and Texas. The High Court ruled in 2013 that the Federal Defense of Marriage Act, which banned the U.S. government from recognizing same-sex marriages conducted in jurisdictions where they are legal, is unconstitutional. The decision opened the door for legal challenges to state laws, and this week, Florida became the 36th state where same-sex couples can legally marry. The Supreme Court is expected to take up the issue at some point because the Sixth Circuit Court of Appeals upheld the laws in Kentucky, Michigan, Ohio, and Tennessee that ban same-sex marriage. Every other appellate court that has decided a case so far has ruled the other way. The justices could decide to hear some or all of the petitions now before them or wait for the new appeals that are certain to come. In New Orleans, Kyle Duncan, a lawyer representing Louisiana, argued that no one knows what the unintended consequences of allowing same-sex couples to legally marry will be. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
In a dramatic scene last night, a coalition of the nation's damaged women staged a drunken, tear-soaked march on the Capitol just after 2 a.m. Jane Carmichael has more.
Thank you, Brooke. The damaged women began their protest yesterday afternoon, marching on the National Mall at about 4 p.m., and then marching away furious, saying they were done with Congress once and for all. But then they came back again late last night, insisting that someone in Washington listen to them for once. The late-night protest started with tearful apologies, but quickly moved to anger as marchers demanded that Congress pass a bill making it illegal to say you love someone and then up and leave as soon as there's one little problem.
Why are you ignoring us? Stop ignoring us! Why don't you hear me when I talk to you? Wipe the smirk off of your face! No, come back! Come back because we think that you... We want you to care about us!
I don't need to pay a therapist to tell me I'm unhappy! I know I'm unhappy!
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you'd like. Live Saturday edition of the program. Should drunk driving be legal? That is what, it's not the question. Jeffrey Tucker's not asking that question. That's what we're asking.
Jeffrey Tucker's making the statement that it should be.
Right. Jeffrey Tucker is one of the authors over at liberty.me. It's actually a site that he founded. Tucker.liberty.me is his blog site, and on there he's asking, or not asking, again he's arguing for the legalization of drunk driving. The consensus so far from the calls tonight, if you haven't been listening to the show, we'll just kind of recap here. A number of people, they support the enforcement of drunk driving laws. However, they are very uncomfortable. Almost everyone who has supported the laws, with the exception of I think one caller tonight, has reluctantly supported them. They only support the existence of them and then using them to go after people who are clearly drunk, as opposed to the wholesale checking of like DUI checkpoint style enforcement. It's actually
and the guy that supported checkpoints he didn't fully support checkpoints. He only supported having them on Friday nights, not all the time.
Right. So it wouldn't inconvenience him.
Right.
So, you know, I don't think that it's necessary. And Daryl, I think you're on board with me here to have these DUI laws. Look, if there's a danger, if there's a dangerous person on the road, that person should be removed from the road.
Right. There's already reckless driving laws. You don't need to add extra charges. It's kind of like the hate crimes legislation
exactly.
that is being added and expanded all the time all across the country to where they're basically making a crime worse than, you know, just being a crime. Oh, it's a crime and it's a hate crime. Oh, you were reckless driving and you were drunk. So it's one of these things to where they do the charge stacking to encourage people to take plea deals
yes.
of, hey, listen, we've got you with two counts of reckless driving, a count of DUI, and not using a turn signal.
Right.
If you plead guilty, then we'll drop one of the reckless driving charges, drop the turn signal charge, and give you a suspended sentence on the other reckless.
That's how they
and
do it.
Then we'll just put this the breath thing in your car for 1 year,
yep.
and then you pay us a fine.
They do that stuff all the time. We're going to continue with your calls and thoughts here. But before we go on, I want to give you a little more from the story, because they actually Jeffrey Tucker actually ends up citing Radley Balco at the very end of the piece here. Quote, "If our ultimate goals are to reduce driver impairment and maximize highway safety, we should be punishing reckless driving. It shouldn't matter if it's caused by alcohol, sleep deprivation, prescription medication, text messaging, or road rage. If law..." And didn't they just outlaw texting in New Hampshire?
Yes. And actually, I believe the way they have it worded is if you touch any electronic device that is not attached to the car. So
wow.
if you have a GPS device that is not one of these that's installed in the car, then you can
ridiculous.
Wind up getting cited. If you touch your cell phone.
This is just going to be a money-making opportunity for the state from top to bottom. So anyway, let's go on here. Road rage, he says here, if lawmakers want to stick it to dangerous drivers who threaten everyone else on the road, they can dial up the civil and criminal liability for reckless driving, especially in cases that result in injury or property damage. Doing away with the specific charge of drunk driving sounds radical at first blush, but it would put the focus back on impairment, where it belongs. It might repair some of the civil liberties damage done by the invasive powers the government says it needs to catch and convict drunk drivers. If the offense were reckless driving rather than drunk driving, for example, repeated swerving over the median line would be enough to justify the charge. There would be no need for a cop to jam a needle in your arm alongside a busy highway. Scrapping the DWI offense in favor of better enforcement of reckless driving laws would also bring some logical consistency to the laws, which treat a driver with a blood alcohol content of 0.08 much more harshly than, say, a driver distracted by his kids or a cell phone call, despite similar levels of impairment. The punishable act should be violating road rules or causing an accident, not the factors that led to those offenses. Singling out alcohol impairment for extra punishment isn't about making roads safer. It's about a lingering hostility toward demon rum. Well, I don't know if I agree with that that last viewpoint. I think it's about making money. This is about bringing money to the attorneys who are going to be the ones who are just raking it in case after case after case, because there's never a shortage of people to get busted for DUI despite all the draconian punishments out there. The people keep coming back, they keep getting drunk, and they keep getting arrested for it. So it's all about the money.
It is, but you know, you do have to admit that there's certainly a level of vendetta against a certain group of people, because if you look at these statistics, it's generally younger people that are going to get hit with DUIs.
And how about poorer people as
poorer
well?
Poorer people. So
who are they more likely to pull over, the guy driving the BMW or the guy driving the old beater?
The guy driving the beater,
yeah.
because most of the time he's not going to be able to afford lawyers
Correct.
To get him off of the charges.
Exactly. Let's go to Eric. He's listening to KNOX in Minnesota. Eric, you're on Free Talk Live. KNOX.
Hey, guys. Yeah, you stole my thunder there. The purpose of these DUI laws is nothing more than to generate revenue for the state. In fact, I think all the traffic stuff is. Here's the question you got to ask. And it's funny, people cannot answer this question. It is this: how do you define a crime? How do you define a crime?
Well, to me, a crime has to have a victim, a complaining party, or in the case of murder or something where the person can't complain, someone who could complain on behalf of, you know, somebody who's been affected by that person being killed. So there has to be a victim. There has to be somebody who's been damaged, had their person damaged or their property damaged. How would you define it, Daryl?
Technically, exactly. Those things are torts. Crime is an offense against the state.
Really? Well, I have my definition of crime. I've never heard that that definition before. Is that the legalese definition?
That's sort of the root of the word. Is, you know, a violation of the state. Am I pretty much spot on there?
What do you think, Eric?
Well, I agree with you. I was going to say it's no damage to person, no damage to property, no crime. See, and even this cop in Virginia doesn't understand that. They want to bust you for something that hasn't even happened. They want to bust you for something that you might do, right? It's like Minority Report. I mean, if a guy goes to the bar, drinks a million beers, gets in his car, drives back home, and pulls into his garage, was a crime committed? No, of course not. And I mean, if he slammed into somebody and killed them, you know, I would agree that would be a crime, but I would think that even if he hadn't been drinking.
Thank you, Eric, for your call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And sure enough, Daryl, the definition of crime, according to dictionary.com, so this isn't the legal definition, this is the general definition, number one does reference the state. It does say, however, an action or instance of negligence that is deemed injurious to the public welfare or morals or to the interests of the state, and that is legally prohibited. So that's the top definition of crimes. It sounds like you're absolutely right there. Now, of course, they do get more general as you go down, number four, any offense, serious wrongdoing, or sin. So, yeah, I guess the standard definition of crime doesn't have to do with an actual victim.
Right. So when you create a victim, then that legally is a tort.
To me, though, English-wise, when I think of the word crime, I think of something that has a victim.
Right. And you know, common language, the way people use words, you know, a crime should have a victim.
No victim, no crime. Let's continue here with your calls and thoughts. We've got Michael. He's in Virginia Beach listening to WNIS. Hello, Michael.
Hello, and yes, we should legalize drunk driving. We should punish damage or injury. Damage to property of persons other than the driver and injury to persons other than the driver. And the death penalty should apply if a drunk driver takes the life of somebody else.
Well, that part I'll disagree with you on, but I liked some of what you were saying. Thanks for the call, Michael. 855-450-FREE. I don't believe in the death penalty. I think that that doesn't help make victims whole. It doesn't make the world whole. 855-450-FREE. You can share your thoughts. It's Free Talk Live.
And now from the Cato Institute, the Cato Constitution Minute. The Declaration of Independence famously states that we all have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. But what do we mean by the pursuit of happiness? Does it mean our happiness may come at the expense of other people? No, because that would deprive others of their rights. And the principle of equal rights rests at the heart of the Declaration. And our founders knew that a large federal government could threaten the pursuit of happiness. Simply put, the pursuit of happiness means liberty, the right to pursue our occupations, our hobbies, our loves, our interests, to do what we think best for our own lives, while respecting the free choices of others, even if we disagree with the choices they make. And that is the liberty protected for us all by the U.S. Constitution. To learn more, visit the Cato Institute online at cato.org.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Hi, I'm Montel Williams. Most of you know me as a talk show host, but I'm also an author, actor, single father of four, a fitness writer, avid snowboarder, and I'm also a medical marijuana patient. Like many of the million people who are living with multiple sclerosis, I'm in pain every single day. And sometimes my nerves are so raw that if you brushed up against me in an elevator, I'd scream. I can't sleep at night from the pain, and sometimes the spasms in my legs are so intense they will wake me up throughout the night. I've tried the strongest prescription medications available, and I'm going to tell you, they do not work. In fact, they leave me in a stupor, and most of the time, it's impossible to even live your life. Now, I've tried medical marijuana, and I'm going to tell you something, it works. If you'd like more information about medical marijuana, you can contact the Marijuana Policy Project at mpp.org or call 1-877-JOIN-MPP.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition of the program. Plenty of time for you with your calls and thoughts about whatever's on your mind, though most people have been calling about drunk driving. Jeffrey Tucker, Radley Balco, among several names in the Liberty movement who have come out in favor of ending the laws against drunk driving. Now, that doesn't mean they support people driving wildly all over the road and getting crazy. It means that they support enforcement of the existing laws on reckless driving. Because why should it matter if you have a little bit of alcohol flowing through your veins versus you're tired because you didn't get enough sleep? I know that when I drove to college when I was younger, there were a couple times when I know I nodded off when I was driving, and those were some of the scariest times I've ever had behind the wheel. And, you know, I wish I hadn't done those things, but, you know, people do that stuff every day, and they're not going to prison over that. It's as dangerous, in my opinion, if not more so. I'm pretty sure that if you did tests, now, I don't know if this has ever been done, it'd be interesting to see. But if you did tests and you took a group of people who were sleep deprived and you tested their driving abilities versus a group of people who'd had two or three beers, almost guarantee you the people who've had two or three beers can be better drivers.
I think the Mythbusters actually did a study on that one time.
And what'd they find out?
I think they found out that the drowsy drivers were just as bad as the drunk drivers.
They were probably getting people drunk, though, right? Like, I just mean compare two or three beers to somebody who's sleepy at the wheel.
Yeah, they
you're not going to nod
off. They used some of their people on a closed course and got them hammered.
Right. Cause, like, if
and then they had somebody stay awake for 24 hours and then drive the same course. But the person that drove the course drowsy was not the same person that drove drunk.
Ah, okay. So apples to oranges in a way.
Apples to pomegranate.
Yeah. Still interesting nonetheless. And yeah, I mean, if you've had two or three beers, you're not going to be nodding off. But if you are tired, man, you can't stop it. I mean, if you are tired enough, nothing you do will keep you awake. And you can try cranking up the tunes. You can try touching yourself. I've tried all of it. Doesn't work.
Okay, so here's what you do, Ian.
What?
You pull over to the nearest gas station.
Yeah.
You buy 2 5-hour energy drinks and a 24-ounce Mountain Dew.
Okay.
You chug them all really, really fast. And then you'll be good for about another hour and a half. And then you repeat.
Yeah, I didn't even think
and
of that.
And then when you get to your friend's house in Jacksonville, Florida on New Year's Day, you've crashed for like 4 hours.
Sounds like you've had experience with this.
Yes.
All right, let's go back to your calls and thoughts here. You can share them with us. It doesn't have to be on drunk driving. This is Free Talk Live. Open phones all the time at 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Mark. He's listening in Grand Rapids to WTKG in Michigan. Hey, Mark.
Hey, how are you guys tonight?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
I do disagree with your assessment. I certainly think drunk driving has a huge public safety interest, and I do not think the existing laws, if you think it through, work.
Because people still drive drunk.
Go ahead. So I'm saying the existing laws with reckless driving would not work if you got rid of OWI or drunk driving type charges.
Nothing will get rid of drunk drivers, right? Obviously, nothing gets rid of them.
The laws are not sufficient for enforcement, and here would be why. Someone that serves over the center lane 2 times because they're looking back at their kids. The reckless driving laws do not have you take that person to jail, okay? You supplant the drunk driving laws with reckless driving laws. What are you going to do to get the person who is double the legal limit off the road and not a danger to the rest of society for the night? Or are you going to now criminalize careless and reckless driving to where you can make custodial arrest for that? I mean, the thing has not been thought through at all.
Well, I'm not proposing legislation here, so we don't have to think it through too far. But I would like to point out that, you know, I'm not advocating somebody get arrested for reckless driving either. I think that, you know, I think that the situation should be assessed. I think each situation should be taken on individually, and that to have some sort of overarching one rule, one size fits all rule, I think is a thoughtless form of enforcement.
In Wisconsin, hold on.
Are you going to take them to jail?
In Wisconsin, a first offense for drunk driving is considered a municipal offense. In New Jersey, any drunk driving offense without a serious injury or death is a traffic violation. It does not sound as though they put people in jail in New Jersey for a DUI, based on the information that I have in front of me, unless
so
they cause an
they
injury or death.
So what do they do with someone that's double the legal limit, smash drunk? They write them a ticket and pull away?
I doubt that. They probably take them home.
In Jersey? I don't know about that.
Or
say,
come with us until somebody can take you home.
Hey, Mark, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Look, to answer his other point, I don't want to see somebody get arrested for reckless driving either. I mean, if somebody's so bad they need to be taken off the road, okay, fine. Take them off the road and take them home. It's not necessary to put somebody in a cage to treat them as though they are a criminal who would harm another person simply because they've made a mistake, they've stayed up too late, or they've had one beer too many or something like that. I'd like to see some compassionate responses to human
or
problems.
That they got kind of sick at work and they took some medicine to take care of the nausea and the sinus ache. And then they're driving home and they start to doze off because they accidentally took, you know, one too many NyQuil liquid gels or whatever it was.
Yeah, that same thing can happen to all those cops. So to have a little bit of empathy for your fellow man, I think, could go a long way.
How many times have you read news stories? Because I know I've read dozens of them about police officers that were drunk on
the
duty.
Job. There was one from Indianapolis a few years ago.
That killed somebody, and then they wound up getting off.
There was a story just like that from Indy a few years ago. Dave is in Indianapolis listening to WIBC. Go ahead, sir.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Hey, good.
Good. Hey, yeah, I just want to reinforce it, you know, I really do feel like it's a money-making scheme. I don't really feel they're creating these laws to help the masses, to protect anybody. Because from, you know, from my understanding and from my own personal experience, you know, you go to court, you get charged, you go to outpatient classes, which the prosecutor is his business partners in, so he makes money.
Oh, yeah.
Send you to the county. County's like, you know, I understand it costs like $85 a day to house an inmate. I've been to the Hilton Chicago. I paid $85 a night there, too. And it's a world of difference. And a lot of also people forget that jail is a business. The state doesn't own it. The city doesn't own it. It's a private business contracted out.
Well, that varies from place to place.
It does. You're right.
But it doesn't matter whether it's
the jails here in town.
But just to be clear, Dave, it doesn't matter whether it's a private business or if it's run by the state. The people who have who are operating these facilities have an interest in having them full.
Right.
Whether it's a private company, they know they might get another contract. If it's the state, they know they're going to expand the bureaucracy.
I forget where it was. There was a private prison that actually sued the state because the inmate population went below a certain percentage.
Dave, anything else you want to share tonight?
Contractual. One last thing. I don't know if people were aware of this. I used to date a girl whose father was a judge, and I didn't know this, but apparently court costs is a fancy way of like what the judge wants to put in the box. So when you go to court for DWI or whatever, you get fined. There's also a court cost. I didn't know that was actually.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
thanks, Dave. More coming up here in moments. It's Free Talk Live. You take control.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Mom, I can't do my math homework. I just don't get it. I hate math.
I've always tried to be a good mother, but when it came to Jamie's math, I was at a loss. Then a friend told me about Math Made Easy DVDs. Concepts are simplified in an easy way to follow and review, and students can learn at their own pace in the convenience of home. Listen, in the frustration, call Math Made Easy. Call now, 1-800-USA-MATH. That's 1-800-872-6284. Or visit us at mathmadeeasy.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Drunk driving laws, are they legitimate and necessary to keep society orderly? Or is it really just a big scam, a huge money-making scam for the lawyer industrial complex? Jeffrey Tucker over at Liberty.me has created a piece that certainly is not original. These things have been thrown out there by libertarians over the years. But his piece is Legalize Drunk Driving. And I think it's a persuasive case that, you know, it's not necessary to have laws against drunk driving, that, you know, reckless driving laws could certainly cover that. And preferably, reckless driving should be enforced with compassion, meaning that the person who is in that situation should, you know, be given some deference if they are clearly a danger and, you know, they're obviously drunk or something like that or way too tired to drive. Then take them home. Don't take them to jail. We don't need to be adding more difficulty to people's lives. I mean, look, if somebody's got a drinking problem, and that's one of the reasons why people keep getting DUIs. As one guy called in earlier tonight, he knew a guy with 25 DUIs. Just, you know, he was drunk at court. This guy just doesn't put the bottle down. So, you know, if you take that person out of their life, whatever life they have, you take them away from their family, their friends, their job, if they have one, and they lose a lot of those things. You know, you get out of jail, you may not have a job waiting for you after that. So what do you think an alcoholic's going to go and do with their time? And now they don't have a job. What do you think they're going to spend their time doing?
Drinking.
Yeah. So, you know, the system doesn't help these people. It just impoverishes them ever further. And as was pointed out previously, they're not going after rich people as much as they are going after poor people, because poor people are the ones who don't know their rights more often, and they don't know, you know, about hiring attorneys and all of that. They can't afford to hire an attorney. So they just get run right over top of by this system and fined hundreds, if not thousands of dollars, inconvenienced, seriously prohibited from driving at all, from even going to work. I mean, this destroys people's lives even worse than the problem that they might have with alcohol. And of course, plenty of people who get DUI charges don't have problems with alcohol. They just had one too many and they, you know, didn't pass the test.
Right.
It's crazy. So you can share your thoughts here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And don't forget, Free Talk Live is brought to you by 101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire. If you've heard about the Free State Project and you love the idea of freedom-oriented people moving together, well, you should just go to freestateproject.org and get signed up. If you're on the fence and you're not sure about this Free State Project thing, you like the concept, but you don't know if it's real, check out the 101 Reasons documentary. Go to 101reasonsfilm.com. The website, I'm pleased to announce, is finally back online. There was some major difficulty that the operators had with the website up until just today. So it's looking pretty again over at 101reasonsfilm.com. And even if the site was having a problem, you can always pull it up on YouTube. So check it out, 101reasonsfilm.com. It's about an hour-long documentary, and it really does an outstanding job of covering the amazing community of liberty-oriented folks and activists that we have here in New Hampshire that have many of whom have made the move already, with over 1,600 here now. Over 16,000 people are pledged to come to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. And maybe, just maybe, someday we'll be able to do something like repeal the DUI ordinances. Now, that's not going to happen anytime soon. But, you know, you shouldn't balk at the idea. I mean, in New Hampshire, they did repeal the knife ban a few years ago.
I would also like to see them repeal the habitual offender.
Or at least, my gosh, yes,
at
please.
Least a lot of the provisions of the habitual offender statute.
Yeah, in New Hampshire, the habitual offender statute results in peaceful people who are just trying to go to work, trying to, like, not drive drunk, but drive while suspended, drive while having their license suspended. These guys are going to prison and jail in New Hampshire.
Well, and it also includes people that have a certain number of speeding tickets.
That's right.
In a 5 or 10 year period of time. So, you know, there are a lot of things that are on there.
It's
other
draconian.
Than just, you know, drunk driving or suspended license. That should definitely not result in someone going to jail for a year.
It's horribly draconian. When I was in jail for civil disobedience, Daryl, I was there with a guy who was there for an entire year. He was driving to work. He was managing a Bickford's, which is like a kind of a Denny's-like chain in the Northeast, from what I understand. And he was, you know, just going to work as a manager at a restaurant chain. He's got kids at home that he's trying to put food on the table for. And, you know, he hadn't paid some ticket in New Hampshire back in the 1990s, and they popped him for it, and he got a habitual offender status and a jail sentence of a year. And this guy was super nice, super cool. You know, he wasn't a danger to anybody. He wasn't driving drunk. He was just driving to work. And while I was in there, the real kicker was there were guys in there for DUI. Now, the guys in there for DUI, one of them was there for 3 days, and the other, he was in for 21 days. While the dude who was driving while suspended was there for a year. So if that doesn't show you crazy state priorities and what's really important to them.
Yeah.
What's really important is you being obedient, not so much whether or not you're driving drunk. Let's go to Colin. He's in Baltimore. You're on Free Talk Live listening to LRN.FM. Hey, Colin.
Hey, how's it going?
What's on your mind?
So I have the idea of civil disobedience that is going to end all civil disobedience.
Whoa, I don't want to end civil disobedience unless you're talking about like it would end the state and then we wouldn't need civil disobedience. What do you mean by that?
I mean it like the metaphor, like it's really, really good. You know?
Okay, give it to me.
Okay, so, and actually let me start off by saying this isn't even originally my idea. They did this back in 2008 in the Netherlands during when they were about to prohibit magical mushrooms over there. And this would be something I'd love to do in Maryland, but I don't have enough liberty-minded following around.
Mm. Okay, so come to New Hampshire.
Well, let's hear the idea first. Go ahead.
Okay, so I think that everyone should buy these magic mushroom spores that you can buy on the internet because they're legal to buy in almost every state in America except for California, Georgia, and Idaho, I believe.
Hmm.
And if we should, and they come in these syringes that and they're filled with liquid. And the spores are in this liquid, and I think we should inject a bunch of these spores into water guns and stand outside a government building and spray it all over the grass outside of a government building.
Would that work, though? I mean, I get mushrooms grow in very specific conditions, right? So, like, you might just do all that work and spend all that money, and then they might not grow.
Well, I mean, they're actually pretty inexpensive anyway.
Are they? Okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah, and that's true. And they might not grow, but I
here's
still
an easier version.
Cool.
Here's a different version, maybe a little bit easier, a little more fun. So Mark, the Prince of Pot, Mark Emery from Vancouver, he came up with this idea years ago called Operation Overgrow, where what you do is you'd save all your marijuana seeds from whenever, you know, or collect them from marijuana smokers. Or there's plenty of marijuana seeds out there, unless, you know, everybody you know only smokes the highest grade marijuana. Anybody that's smoking regular or mid-grade cannabis,
if they're buying it from a guy on the street,
yeah,
they're going to have some seeds.
Have them save the seeds, and then come springtime, or, you know, if you're in Florida, anytime, you can just go out in front of the police department and city hall and along the medians and wherever and just start throwing these seeds. And, oh, I guarantee you, you will have growth of marijuana plants, because we're talking about weeds here. And, there's a reason they're called weeds, because they'll grow in all kinds of circumstances and they're, yes, relatively hard to get rid of. So that is one that you'll see results relatively quickly. And it's a lot of fun to do that one. So that's what I'd recommend. But either way, Colin, you definitely, if you care about freedom, you should get to New Hampshire. And I thank you for the call tonight. Let's continue with you and your thoughts. Bobby is in Lakeland. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Bobby.
Yeah. What's going on, guys?
We're doing a radio show.
First off, I wanted to say that I don't think there's nothing wrong with touching yourself.
No, of course not. There are a lot of people who think there is something wrong with it, though. So I don't know what brought that about as far as a comment. Did someone tell you there's something wrong with self-pleasuring?
No. You said you alternately talked about touching yourself, and I just wanted to say it. I mean, I don't think there's nothing wrong with it.
Oh, yeah, you mentioned it as something to keep you awake if you're drowsy.
Hey, thanks, Bobby, for the call tonight. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. It didn't work. I mean... It
puts you to sleep.
No. More coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
Hi, everyone. I'm Chuck Woolery. After putting a few thousand couples together on Love Connection, you know that nothing kills romance faster than bad breath. Smart Mouth gets at the cause of bad breath without the burn, and you get clean breath for about 12 hours. Other mouthwashes only prevent bad breath for about an hour. Gum and mints, they just cover it up. Use Smart Mouth in the morning for great breath all day. Rinse in the evening for clean, kissable breath all night. You can even wake up without morning breath. Smart Mouth, for 12 hours of real clean breath, look for the green box at your favorite store.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
The knowledge of the ancients, tried and true, trusted herbs and extracts fused with the latest nutraceutical science. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. For the last 2 years, our team has been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to develop the ultimate nutraceutical formulation. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure Ancient Defense for you and your family. Visit AncientDefense.com or call 888-253-3139. That's AncientDefense.com.
Anyone can publish on the internet, but not everyone is publishing material suited for online reading. According to the Yahoo Style Guide, it cautions that internet content has a few seconds, three or less, to encourage people to read more, to take action, or navigate to another one of your pages. So make it easy for readers to pick and choose. Isn't that the way you poke around online? Use short words, short sentences, short paragraphs, bulleted lists, and short pages. Front load what you write, putting the most important information at the beginning of headlines and paragraphs and sentences. Same goes for your keywords. What someone would likely type into the search box on Yahoo or Google. For more tips on communicating better online or in a job interview or everyday life, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Every day you make investment decisions. When you do business with and hold U.S. dollars, you make an investment in the soundness of the moral philosophy and the potential longevity of the United States hegemony. People who claim a monopoly on violence around the world. If this is the investment that you want to make, please keep listening to LRN.FM. If not, stop using their currency. Use bitcoins. Get educated. We use coins.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You may dial toll-free here. Although, if you're already on the line, we're going to do our best to get you on here. If not, if you don't get in tonight, well, no worries. We're going to be here tomorrow. I'll have Adamo Freeman joining me from copblock.org, and we'll take your calls at any time. You know, whenever we're on the air, we're on 7 to 10 at night Eastern time, 7 nights a week. So if you don't get in one night, just call the next night. You don't have to be on topic necessarily to call Free Talk Live, although it does help. Like if, you know, if we're talking about DUI laws, if you're calling about that topic, you're likely to get on sooner than somebody who's calling to talk about frozen juice pops. Which is, I don't know how the hell we got on that conversation, Daryl. What was the
I'm playing with your buckyballs, and I made something that looks like the weird triangle I mentioned to you between segments.
Yeah, the old
Remember that old treat that looked like this?
We couldn't figure out for a while what it was called, but you Googled around and figured out they were the Minute Maid Fruit Juicies.
Yeah, and then there was another brand called Smooze and something called Icy Juicy.
Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. All right, let's continue here and go with your calls and thoughts. Scott is listening in Indy to WIBC. Hello, Scott.
Hi, how are you?
Welcome, sir. Good.
Yeah, I was calling because 70% of the time I can agree with libertarians, and this is one of the 30% of the time where I confirm to myself that, no, I'm still not a libertarian. I'm a conservative, and I'll probably remain that way for the rest of my life. I mean, it's an interesting idea, but then I look at it and go, well, do we really let people on the highway, for instance, with, say, have a car carrier, for instance, and we notice that one of the cars is not secured down, it might fall off, but we'll just wait until something happens, and then we'll do something about it. Or do you have, you wouldn't prosecute, now, admittedly, this is not a prosecutorial case, but you'd have a state trooper stop the car carrier, warn him of the possibility of danger, and have it resecured. But if
well,
you have someone
duh.
Drinking
I mean,
driving,
if something's dangerous,
what,
then somebody that should be brought to the driver's attention.
Exactly. And
but somebody should not go to jail driving. For not having their luggage secured properly.
But this is quite a bit of a different thing. Having something that comes undone, something like that is something that could happen through an accident, through any of a number of things, mechanical failure. But drinking and driving comes through what is called willful disregard. And willful disregard is when you do something that is certainly, you know, I'll have to use the word reckless. I know you're going to talk about reckless driving too, but it is a reckless thing to do. It is something that is 100% preventable.
So is drowsy driving.
But when you say that they can't help themselves because they're an alcoholic, you're just taking, you're taking both parts of free will out of the whole equation. You're saying they're not accountable for their bad actions.
I didn't say that.
Therefore,
I didn't say that at all. If somebody's a danger, they shouldn't be on the road. I mean, that seems pretty obvious. What we're saying is that someone shouldn't be punished for the reason they're a danger on the road. You know, there's all kinds of reasons why someone could be a dangerous driver. And I don't care if they're eating a sandwich, yelling at someone in the back seat, incessantly changing the radio station, or whatever. If they're a danger to others, then it makes sense to remove them from the road. But, you know, to punish somebody just because they've crossed some arbitrarily selected number chosen by politicians just doesn't make any sense to me. And now, conservatives, doesn't being a conservative mean being for small government?
I am for small government. However, I'm not going in that direction right at the moment. I am saying, speaking of someone who had a car totaled by a drunk driver, he was 0.32. Now, admittedly, that was a clear-cut case. He caused property damage. However, you know, he was four times over the legal limit, I beg your pardon, and he was drunk to the point where he was in the hospital over 8 hours after the accident before I could get the information to my insurance and get the whole thing sorted out.
Did you ever follow up what happened with the guy?
Let's put it this way. When I finally got a hold of his insurance company, they were trying to do their best not to hint at what the situation was, but the lady on the phone kind of gave out this long sigh when she heard that he'd had a drunk driving incident. She goes, oh, that's too bad. And without her saying it, and that was all she said, I realized he was a habitual offender and he had done this before. And this
so what good has it done? What good? Look, think about it from this way. You're getting punished twice, right? Like, as a small government conservative, shouldn't you support having smaller government budgets? And what I'm pointing out here is that not only are you being punished by you have to deal with the hassle, the costs of, you know, calling insurance companies and all the time and effort that that takes, and if court if necessary, then they put this guy in jail. You're paying for that. You're the one who's paying for the jailing of this man.
If he'd been in jail, he wouldn't have caused the accident, sir. That's the whole problem.
You can't keep him in jail forever.
As a citizen, you have to be accountable for both ends of it. You have to be accountable for when you do right, and you have to be accountable for when you do wrong. And the whole idea of allowing drunk drivers on the road is just absurd. I'm sorry, it's absurd.
They're already on the road. Nothing's stopping them from getting on the road.
I do believe the government over-prosecutes in quite a few areas, and I do have a problem with that. However, when it comes to drunk driving, it is 100% preventable. Saying that they're drunk,
have you ever had two beers and driven home?
And they're not. And I'm going to keep talking. Saying that they're drunk and that they are unaccountable for their actions because they just can't.
I didn't say they were unaccountable. I don't know if you've been listening to the same show we've been doing.
Sir, if you say you don't punish them, that is a whole permissive parent thing. Okay.
I didn't say you don't punish them, sir. I said you take them home rather than put them in a prison cell. But if they've caused damage, then they need to make restitution.
The kid keeps misbehaving. And he keeps getting a slap on the wrist. Eventually, he's going to.
Do you think paying medical bills for the rest of someone's life is a slap on the wrist?
I would prefer that person not get to that point.
Well, you don't get to choose whether or not someone gets behind the wheel drunk. They're doing that anyway. I've never said they shouldn't be held responsible. If somebody does damage, they should make restitution. Do you not agree, Scott, that if someone does damage to your property, they should make restitution to you?
Well, certainly. But
we're in agreement on that point.
I'm going to illustrate absurdity by being absurd. But you don't let somebody go out there with, say, a bolt-action rifle, a high-powered rifle, start shooting around your farm and, you know, hitting your barns and all that, hitting your buildings, and then wait till somebody gets either killed or wounded.
Obviously, they're doing damage to someone's property in that case, whether or not someone gets killed. You don't want to let somebody do that.
But suppose it doesn't. You hear bullets whizzing over your house. You see bullets whizzing over your house. There's a guy up there in the hill. You don't just wait, quick, now he's been damaged. Let's prosecute him now. No, you see somebody who's doing something that is clearly a very dangerous thing. You don't say, hey, you know, put the rifle away.
Right, and there are laws against reckless driving. There are already laws against reckless driving.
So what you're saying is that as a supposedly small government guy, Scott, I can't keep talking over you like that. I'm trying to ask you a question. I'm trying to follow up with what you've said.
Because
you can't have a conversation? So what I'm trying to find out here is, so you support enforcing these laws with jail. Is that right?
I expect to enforce the laws with jail for gross negligence. Yes, I do.
How long should someone be in jail for a first DUI offense?
Well, speaking of someone whose brother went to jail for it years ago, I think he should get punished. However, after all, the people do speak through the law, and they say, well, let's deem what would be appropriate for this. He hasn't done it again.
I'm asking you, what do you think is appropriate? 30 days? 5 days? 100 years?
I'm not going to put a number on it. Uh-huh. I don't know that at all. All I know is that you have to decide on it. But, you know, telling
you don't have to decide.
The
You're copping out on the discussion. Thanks for the call, Scott. Law and order, but he doesn't know what the law should be.
Or what the order should be.
He'll just let some politicians decide because, you know, he trusts them being a small government conservative and all. Let's continue here. We've got Mark. He's in St. George, Utah. You're on Free Talk Live, Mark.
Thanks for taking my call. Try and make this quick because I know it's a few minutes.
Sure.
One of the most – I got a DUI a few years ago, and it's one of my least proud moments, and it really did help to get me in a better spot in my life. However, one of the things that I found the most frustrating about the circumstance was that the state opens two cases against you. They open a criminal case against your driving under the influence, and then they open an administrative case against your license.
That's right.
And during the course of the time that I was being processed – I refused a breathalyzer test because I didn't want to take one. And I asked for an attorney to be there when I did take one. And they said, you don't have the right of an attorney to be there when you take one. So what they eventually did, that's what they told me. They said, you do not need an attorney here for us to give you this breathalyzer test. And so what they did is they called a judge and he issued an order for them to take a blood draw from me.
Wow.
And gave a warrant. Probable cause because you refused.
No, exactly. And what happens with that situation is what happened was regardless of whether my blood tested over the limit, which I ended up basically getting, it got reduced to something called a wet reckless. It was in California, which is essentially a reduced sentence. It's kind of like driving impaired. And but what happened was because I refused, I had already apparently signed a contract, which I didn't know when I signed a driver's license thing, saying that if I refuse a chemical test,
screwed.
It is an automatic year suspension.
We'll be back tomorrow. FreeTalkLive.com. In the meantime, have a great weekend. Thanks, Mark.
Do you try?
Free Talk Live.
For the listeners, each talk show has like a, you're in the Joe Blow Army, or, you know, the Ditto Heads. Do the lefties have it too?
I couldn't tell you.
Ed Heads, isn't
it? Yep, Ed Heads.
Yeah, Ed Heads. So they all have them. I really want
to
hear
from you. I'd like to rename our listeners Mindless Free Talk Live Zombies. What do you think?
Free call Talk in, Live Automatons.
Call in if you're a Mindless Free Talk Live Zombie.
What does it mean to you to be left? What does it mean to you
progressive.
To be right? What does it mean to you to be conservative? What does it mean to you to be liberal? I think they're very vague concepts that pit people against one another. Many people who otherwise, in the absence of being able to plaster themselves with that label, might find out they've got an awful lot in common.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, January 9th, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,211, silver at $16.44, and Bitcoin is trading around $297.96. Today's precious metal price is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. With civil unrest occurring all across the country, being food secure has never been more important. Visit eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, on Thursday, a bill to approve the construction of the Keystone XL oil pipeline passed another barrier in the Senate. The Senate Energy Committee approved the measure with a 13-9 vote. The bill will go before the full Senate next week, while the House of Representatives is scheduled to vote on Friday. A federal judge in California has overturned a ban on the sale of controversial foie gras, duck or goose liver, which has been fattened through force feeding. Foie gras involves deliberately fattening the animals by force feeding corn through a feeding tube. U.S. District Judge Stephen V. Wilson permanently blocked the state attorney general from enforcing a law which banned the practice. Judge Wilson made his decision based on the argument that the federal government's authority trumps the state's. Activists from across the political spectrum were organizing a global day of action against the use of torture on January 31st. In response to a lack of media coverage and action from politicians following the release of the Senate report on CIA torture, a number of organizations are calling for rallies and protests across the globe to stand in solidarity with victims of torture. The Anti-Media, the Conscious Resistance Network, the Solutions Institute, and a growing list of activist groups and media outlets are joining the calls for action. Several cities are planning on hosting mock waterboarding and force-feeding presentations. Today's broadcast of Liberty Beat is made possible by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Did you know you can support the Liberty Beat when shopping on Amazon.com? Just log into your account after clicking our Amazon affiliate link at libertybeat.com/Amazon. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 9th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. The accused operator of the Deep Web Silk Road Marketplace is set to go to trial. Catherine Bleich has this Liberty Beat special report.
Many of you know that in late 2013, the online Bitcoin black market, known as the Silk Road, was shut down. The alleged founder, Ross Ulbricht, was arrested and charged with conspiracy to traffic drugs, launder money, and even murder for hire in the state of Maryland. This month, he will go on trial for many of these charges in the state of New York. The Liberty Beat is pleased to announce that we will be there to report live from the courtroom the entire first week. With a generous donation from Roger Ver, also known as the Bitcoin Jesus, the Liberty Beat's Derek Bros is one of several activists who have been funded to travel to New York to serve as our eyes and ears. We hope to also send the Liberty Beat's founder and editor-in-chief, John Bush. The two plan to work in tandem as they live blog the courtroom actions, write narrative pieces, interview key people, and create audio media. Help us send our amazing team into the belly of the beast to document this historic trial by visiting thelibertybeat.com/support. You can expect the mainstream media to only paint a small part of the picture. Let the Liberty Beat bring you the truth. To learn more about Ross and his case, visit freeross.org.
Today's edition of the Liberty Beat is sponsored by My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at mymagicmud.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your messenger product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more, visit libertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 9th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
This is the Onion Week in Review. In light of reports this week of a Russian crime ring stealing 1.2 billion username and password combinations from internet users, experts from top security firms across the country reportedly advised Americans to refrain from clicking on anything at all. The nation's top security specialists warned individuals to actively avoid any scrolling or swiping on the internet.